ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and lovers of drones everywhere. Can you hear me now? I don't think you can, because I'm not getting any audio thingies.
Hang on, I thought they said that they were hearing sound.
You can hear me now. You can? Even though we're not... All right, I'll go with it. Hey, everybody, welcome to the show. What I was saying before, I apologize, I will delete the 11 false starts of this. Kelly, please tell me your mic works.
Check, one, two,
okay,
one, two.
Good. Are you just going to sit there and mess with me? So what I was saying before, we all good? We good? Works now? There? Okay. It's my birthday, and what the fates got me was a screwed up beginning to the show. And what I do, Kelly's known me for many, many years, what I do when I'm frustrated and angry, I just yell out into the ether and I say horrible things, awful, terrible words. It'll scare your grandmother. But anyway, we're back. Are we all good? Is everything good? Can you hear me? We good? No sound. Cliff says no sound. Mark Rogers said we good. Cliff says no sound. Mine says offline. What in the hell is going on?
I'm thinking people need to restart their browsers if they're having, because of the multiple restarts.
Maybe they're on an old stream.
Yeah. Yes, it's probably sharing the chat from an old stream or something. It's working. OzByDrone says it's working. So I'm going to go with that. Welcome to the show. It is we're in a new location. I've moved the studios. I've been working all week to get this stuff going right. And this is coming at you in glorious 1080p. Let me just go ahead and focus the camera. I'm not really saying bye-bye. I'm just using it to focus the camera here like I do. Here we go. All right. Oh my goodness, Kelly, are you gonna say any words, or are you just gonna let me wave out in the wind?
No, I was busy writing down all the new words I learned from you before the show started.
Okay, well, it should look better. I mean, you should be able to see all the horizontal wood in his shot and the vertical paneling in mine. I'm calling this the paneling palace. And here is camera two. This is what I've been working on the whole time.
Oh, wow.
So,
that's a lot of paneling.
It is. This house was built in like 1901 or something. It's a way old house. You can see my face is red in glorious 1080p. On the show today, we've got, of course, Kelly Green is hosting. We've got Wolfgang Weber. He's photographer and a drone guy and an actor. He lives in California. He works with B. Brennan from Droner. He's going to be on later.
Is his real name Wolfgang?
It really is. Yeah, his real name is Wolfgang. Isn't that cool? You know his wife calls him Wolfie or something cute like that. And then later on, we're going to talk with a guy named John Smithers, who has some incredible video. Right place, right time. But right now, I'm going to let somebody else talk because my voice is trashed. And let's do the news.
Stop the music. It's time for news.
Let's head on over into the drone newsroom with everything you'd ever want to know about drones. It's Jeff Sales. What's happening?
Oh, not bad. I was just trying to write down some of those words, too.
Yeah, don't share them with your kids.
So to start the show off on a friendly note, our friend Chris Rollins recently was in the news.
Oh, that's right. Chris made the news. Check this out.
New at 6 tonight. It was a weird day, to say the least, for some folks in Tyler today. While testing out some new equipment for a roofing company, the workers found a surprise of their own. KHK's Matt Thibodeau joins us now to tell us more about it all. Matt.
That's right, Trent. A weird day indeed. Crews were busy at work when a stray dog appeared on the roof above them to check out what they were up to.
It was just another Tuesday at Avco Roofing. A crew was out videoing a new way of disposing roof shingles when suddenly...
How'd you get up there?
Pedal.
He's a roofer.
We
we all sort of did one of these and like, what? And we were sort of pointing at it. And then we were looking around like, is this a joke? Like, where is this dog coming from?
It turns out the dog had climbed a ramp, jumped across at least two other roofs, and eventually got stuck near where the roofers were working.
Yeah, hardcore parkour.
To make sure the doggo was okay without risking scaring it off the roof, they took to the skies for a bird's eye view.
Definitely not something we see every day. We've seen a lot of weird things on roofs, you know, weird holes and tears and damage. Dogs, no, that's not very normal.
Eventually, animal control and the fire department came, hoping they could get the frightened canine down safely.
They were trying to figure out how to get the dog to trust them and come near to them.
But the dog had other plans. As it turns out, they were dealing with quite the athlete.
He jumped back 3 feet up onto the other section of roof, shimmied along, went down onto another section of roof, jumped back across onto the other building, down that roof, and then back onto the ground.
The day resumed, but everyone carried on with a smile, knowing full well it will be a story to share for years to come.
Yeah, this is going to be one of those stories that anytime a new employee comes, oh, you weren't here when the dog got stuck on our roof. Very, very, very eventful day. I've never seen anything like this.
Now, after getting off the roof, the dog ran towards some houses somewhere. The dog is likely smiling, knowing he pulled the best bamboozle of the day.
Did they just say parkour, as in parkour for dogs? Is that what they said? By the way, this story has been brought to you by Pigeon Jerky, the Cadillac.
You'll enjoy Pigeon Jerky, Pigeon Jerky, the Cadillac of processed meats.
Yeah.
You'll enjoy Pigeon Jerky, Pigeon Jerky, and you'll give your family a treat. It's balanced nutrition to help them grow.
Yeah.
And it's full of fiber to make them go.
You enjoy Pigeon Jerky.
Pigeon Jerky. The Cadillac of processed meats. Yeah. Yeah. Yep. All kinds of stuff are screwing up tonight. All kinds of stuff. But it's all right. It doesn't bother me any. I'm just the easygoing, whatever happens, happens kind of guy. You know me.
Just be creative. Why not? It's your birthday. Why not?
Oh, my God.
All right.
I'm dying over here. Hold on a second. I have to say, I think I missed a super chat. It was $22 or something. My chat won't let me scroll back that far. I think I hurt my throat yelling. I have to tell you guys, all the stuff that I do for this, it really bothers me that I was 15 minutes late with the show. It really, really does. I'm committed to this. I've worked all week setting this stuff up, moving it from the radio station to my house. I had 4 days instead of just 2 days to prepare this. And it's going to be a big bang-up show, but something like that speed bump really just affects me. But thank you very much for the super chats. And Mark H., oh my goodness, happy birthday, Kim, with a $50 super chat. That makes my throat feel a little bit better. It does. And now back to Jeff in the newsroom. Thank you very much, Mark H. Thank you.
All right. For those of you that get FAA notifications, you probably received an email this afternoon from the FAA discussing the dangerous drones and weapons. They've apparently released an email identifying that, or try to reiterate to everybody that operating a drone that has a dangerous weapon attached to it is a violation of Section 363 of the FAA Reauthorization Act. And it is I got your tongue stuff.
Both of you guys, just step out of the way. I'll take the show from here.
You got it, man.
The civil penalties for this can be $25,000 for each violation unless the operators receive specific authorization from the FAA to put a weapon on their drone. So sticking fireworks on your drone is weaponizing your drone.
Yeah.
Don't do it.
Now, is dropping an egg from your drone, is that considered a weapon?
No. They're talking about things that are launched from the drone, as in, you know, like projectiles.
Okay, so you can still drop like a water balloon on your friend.
Yes.
Okay. Yes. All right. Oh my goodness. Metro Drones. Wow. $20 super chat. Once upon a drone, 58 days until spin up. Happy birthday, young man. Yeah, I'm 53 today. 53. How old are you, Kelly?
52, baby.
Yeah, I'll wait right here for you to catch up.
Still just a kid.
Tony T, thank you. 20 pound super chat. Hey, Ken, set my alarm for this. Happy birthday, my friend. thank you so much for the birthday super chats. I really appreciate it. Oh, and
all right, so next
every year, I don't know if I ever told you this. I told Kelly this. Every year, I call my mom at 4:04 a.m. That's when I was born. Every year for decades, I can't remember when it started. And this year, I recorded part of it, and I'll share it with you. Kelly, you know how I talk to my mom sometimes.
Trust me when I say you don't want to hear this.
It'll be a little awkward for some.
You'll cringe.
It's cringeworthy. Oh, absolutely. But put in the chat, if you know the exact time you were born, put that in the chat. I'm surprised. I'd be curious to see how many people actually know that. What time were you born, Jeff?
I have the foggiest idea.
Really? You don't know?
I was April 10th, 1969, but as for what time of day, I have no idea.
Kelly, what time?
4:04 a.m.
You were not.
I have no idea.
You don't know? Who doesn't know what time they're born? Look at all the people. 11:34, 3:16 a.m. A lot of a.m.s.
Let me guess. You were the firstborn child.
Yeah.
Of course. Jeff, you probably weren't the firstborn child.
I'm the only child.
Oh, you should know what time you were born. Know. I was the secondborn child. I don't have any clue. My parents don't even know.
You know what? I hate to derail the news like this. Kelly, there are no childhood pictures of Kelly. That is for real.
That's true.
His mother took a whole bunch of pictures of his older sister, but there's none of him. Isn't that sad? That's sad.
You should see my mom's house. Pictures of my sister hanging everywhere when she was a baby. They've got a painting. They've got a painting of her as a toddler hanging in one of the rooms that's yay big. I'm not even sure. Maybe I was adopted. Who knows? But I don't know the whole story.
But it doesn't bother you, right?
Doesn't bother me a bit.
No.
Let me check some of these words that I learned from you earlier today because I'm about to spout them out.
Mappers 2, thank you for $1.50 super chat. And now we return to the news.
So next we have the Harry Potter drone show at Universal Studios. They brightened up the summer skies over Hogwarts.
This is fantastic. Check out that deer. It actually moves its head. Look at that.
These are the actual Intel drones being used at Universal Studios Hollywood.
Wow. That's really impressive. One day, they'll be doing full, like, runs, and I mean, this is the early days of this kind of thing. It'll get more and more impressive.
So next we have something that's, I guess, a little bit strange. In running through the news, I came across this little video. Apparently a gentleman was talking about how he was flying his drone through a wind turbine. This wasn't exactly what I thought was the best of results.
Oh
no.
Wind turbines are fun. But you have to remember to get out of their way.
Yeah, and it's a long fall.
Yeah, I'll play it again. You'd think he would. What do you think the pilot was looking at when this was happening?
I have no idea. You've actually done this.
You're right.
You have flown through these before. And so I'm going to have to defer to your expert knowledge as to what you think was going through that guy's brain.
Yes, Kelly?
It's going so slow. How could he mess that up?
Right. That's what I thought. Now, here is a successful trip through from your pal Ken from a few years back. This was in Texas.
Yeah, this one had me crawling out of my seat the first time I saw it.
If you're going to go through, make sure you go through at the hub, not at the... They go faster the further out you go.
So is it harder than it looks?
Yeah, it is.
Okay.
But boy, it's satisfying when you finally do it.
I'm sorry, but after repairing so many drones, just looking at that just makes my body cringe. I'm like, God.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so next we have something that was kind of fun. the Lincoln police are looking for information on a case involving the theft of an underwater drone. This underwater drone is apparently 150 pounds and is a one-of-a-kind drone. I mean, this thing is like what you use for like deep wrecks. Had no information as to whether or not they've caught anybody, but if you have any information, be nice and share it with the Lincoln Police Department.
It looks like you can put some, like a toddler in there, maybe.
Oh, yeah. This thing is huge. So, 150 pounds.
I just realized Deep Rex is a great name for a rock band.
Deep Rex, yeah. You know, I lived in Lincoln, Nebraska.
No, I did not know that.
Yeah, and that's where I saw my first tornado in person. And hopefully my last. Oh, oh, Media Mike, $5 super chat. Happy birthday, Ken. Thank you, Media Mike. And Chris Rollins, $2 super chat. Thanks, Chris. Buddy. Chris, hey, man. Thank you. Thanks, man. You look good on the news.
All right. So the DJI Robomaster recently was, showcased in Farmer Derek's video where he decided to use it in a new way with cows.
All right, here we go.
I like the music.
Wah, wah, wah. He shot the laser at him.
I'm gonna drive back and see if it's all in.
I'm surprised that they're moving at all.
Hey. Oh, they followed the thing around. I mean, the video is exceptionally long. They followed that thing around for a long time. It was hilarious.
Wow.
Yeah.
And that is pretty much the only use for that thing. Sorry, I'm not a fan of that thing.
DJI is pushing really hard to take that RoboMaster idea. They've actually got a RoboMaster competition that they're sponsoring.
Yeah, no, I'm just kidding, of course. I understand that. But from a photography and drone perspective, it's kind of useless. Unless you have kids that are into that kind of thing. And that's really what it's for. Wes Dunn, thank you so much for the $20 super chat. Happy birthday. Thanks so much. You know what? This feels better than... Remember when your grandma would stuff a $5 bill in a birthday card?
No.
No? Your grandmother never did that?
No.
For real? Kelly, sit back on the couch and tell me about your mother. What is going on with you, man? Your grandmother never put like a dollar bill or $2 bill in a birthday card?
Oh, she did put a $3 bill in a birthday card once.
Okay. Joe Blaylock, thank you so much for the $10 super chat. Love the show, Ken. Thank you so much. Grumpy. Hey, Mr. Grumpy. Grumpy the blogger. Hopefully the rest of your birthday goes off without a hitch. Man, I hope so. And we got the new interwebs here. I just want to know, does it look better? This is 1080. Does it look better?
I got to say, right off the bat, your hair looks fabulous.
Yeah, and you can see all the grain in this 70s Brady Bunch wall special happening here. Yeah. Oh my goodness, UAV of Texas, $20 super chat. Goodness, happy birthday, Ken. I'm starting to feel better now. This has turned into a great day. Thank you very much, you guys. I appreciate it. And to our guests who are waiting in the wings, thank you for your patience. We had a rough start. We'll get to you, I promise. And now back to the news.
All right, so the FAA, again, is also in the news because, as you know, they're working on coming out with a new aeronautical knowledge test. And one of the things that they're doing at the moment is seeking stakeholders for input into this, this new operator's test. So they're reaching out to a lot of different groups, a lot of different, entities to get feedback from the recreational pilots, advocacy groups, et cetera, as to what should be included in that new knowledge test. So be on the watch out for that.
Very good. All right.
So EHang is also in the news. We remember them because they created one of the first functional flying taxis. And they've announced recently that they're going to open up their service in Guangzhou metropolis in China. They're going to actually have these mobility systems flying all over the city. as part of one of their first implementations.
Well, that's great. I like to see advancements like that. I'm not going to step foot in one, but it sounds like a lot of fun for those who don't care about their life. No, I'm sure it's fine. Let me try my first roll off in 1080.
Ah, yes. All right.
Do you like going this way? Back. Or should I go the other way? Should I roll off the other way? The table's in the way over there.
Yeah, just roll back.
Okay.
All right. So.
Hold on. Hold on. Because.
Holding.
I can't scroll back. Quentin Thompson, thank you. $5 super chat. I love the new setup, Ken. Do you like it? Can you see? This desk belonged to my grandfather. And when he passed, it went over to my grandmother's house. And then, of course, I inherited it. So here it is on the interwebs. It's a perfect little desk there. Mike Young, RSP Drone Photography, $10 super chat. Happy birthday, Ken. Thanks for many years of being such a great guy to the drone community. Here's to many more, buddy. Aw, thank you so much. I'd rather spend my birthday with no one else than you guys.
Because that's all you have is no one else.
That's right. I don't have any real friends. And by real friends, I mean tangible, like, you guys are real friends. But I meant, like, friends that I can, like, shake hands and... And, oh my goodness, Robert Rutter. Thank you. $1.99 super chat from Robert Rutter. Rutter, I hardly know her.
Come on.
Ow! And Williams Aerial Media, $1.49 super chat. You know, thank you very much. You know, sometimes YouTube will give you like $2 or whatever to give out for some reason. And, you know, like a free super chat for, and I suspect that's one of them. And I thank you for thinking of me.
The next super chat has got the best last name.
Daniel, I'm going to let Jeff say it.
La Jeunesse.
Thank you. $4, is that Canadian?
It looks like French.
French.
This is bon fête, so.
Okay. Yeah. Bon fête, Ken. Thanks.
What is bon fête? What am I missing here?
Oh, that's that's the kind of bone that you get for your dog. It's a bon fête? No? I don't know.
Yeah.
I think it says happy birthday, right?
Oh,
probably.
Yeah. Oh my goodness, Manic Magic, $5 super chat. You guys are so nice to make me feel better. Cause, man, if my rant when the show is supposed to start between 6:56 and whenever the show finally started, that was bad news. That was some turbo. I think I had a little panic attack for realsies. Anyway. Oh my goodness, we got some super stickers. Stickers!
Stickers, I like stickers, yes I do. Stickers, stickers, I like stickers more than you. Stickers.
We got one from John Scott for $10. Thank you for the super sticker. It's a little dude taking a bow, thank you. And now back to the news once again.
Right. There's a good question right after that John Scott super chat. Somebody says, where's Henry? Because you're doing the show from home now. Where is Henry right now?
That's a good question. See, Henry is blind. And he has a problem coming up these stairs. They're kind of high because it's an older house. And I don't know, there weren't regulated stair height. And so he can't do that. And, I'll give you the whole story. There are wooden stairs, and his feet would slip. So I put little carpet pieces on it, and he's afraid of the carpet pieces. So he won't come up. I'll have to carry him up. But he's downstairs listening to the show. Simple Home Brew. We're never going to get to through the news, Jeff. We're just never
going
to.
Yeah, I know.
And that's fine. Simple Home Brew, $10 super chat. Thank you. Number one fan. I like those super chat. K-Daddy times 4. Thank you for the $2 super chat. Very nice. And yes, Shane McKenna. I see everybody else wish me happy birthday. Honestly, my eyes For some reason, it's the background. The color of the super chats allows me to read them better. But I do see the other chats, and I do go back and I watch the entire show. I do, and this is going to be my favorite part to watch back. Yeah. I mean, the show's off the rails. Why put it back on now? I don't want to miss anybody. Robert Moore, $5 super chat. Oh my goodness, happy birthday, Ken. Good to have you back, Jeff. Yes, it is good to have Jeff back. Jeff was deathly ill last week. And Donnie Meinsmer. Happy birthday, Ken. You're a wealth of information and a hoot. Awesome. My goodness. All right. And now back to
okay, so first responders were recently given an interesting drone challenge.
Oh, yes, they were.
The State Preparedness Testing Center is designed for first responders to practice real-life situations. Particularly today, they were testing out the use of drones.
This technology is amazing. It allows us to more quickly deploy resources so that we can get situational awareness to understand emergency situations and what we need to do to respond. We can do that in a matter of minutes sometimes with this technology. So whereas in the past we might have to use a helicopter or some other type of asset that was much more expensive and it took longer to deploy, drone technology is much quicker and is much cheaper, and it allows us to avoid sometimes putting first responders in harm's way because we can use the technology to do that instead. And that's what it's all about.
Agencies who are interested in using drones can start by taking the awareness course. After, they can graduate to the operating course, which teaches first responders how to fly the drones.
You're looking at your screen, you're looking at your landmarks, you're watching your height, your distance, your speed, you're working at obstacles. You always have to be careful of obstacles because you don't want to crash the aircraft, and then you don't have anything you're going to be using.
Coel says it is important to be thorough by doing a secondary search. However, getting to the victims as quickly and as safely as possible is the main goal.
Yes, it is. And avoid those obstacles.
That obstacles.
He did say obstacles, didn't he?
Yes, he did.
WhizBang99, wow! $20 super chat. He says, I found it in the parking lot. All yours. Warren Fire Department when lighting candles. Will do. And, B! Hey, man! $5 super chat from Droner Tech. Yeah, B. Brendan, he was going to be the original guest tonight, but he's way too busy for us because he's a superstar. And so he got his buddy Wolfgang to be on, who is equally, if not more interesting, than Brendan. Equally as good looking, too. And thank you so much. I should be here. This is Brendan. I'm watching. Okay, cool.
All right, so Google founder Larry Page had been working, and we reported this in the news previously, on the Kitty Hawk drone. It's been confirmed now that this drone has finished its 25,000th flight as part of the extensive training test being done in Las Vegas.
Oh, wow. Okay. Check it out. This is probably one of the most stable. If I had to ride one of these, this is probably the one I would ride.
My only dream from my childhood, I remember, was when I could fly. And it was such an amazing feeling that from that point on, I just felt it has to be real.
I remember Casey Neistat rode that once, didn't he?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
I know that quite a few people have been riding this thing, and it's a very safe device. I'm really impressed with it.
Yeah, apparently it doesn't take long at all to learn the thing either.
No, in fact, the facility that they had out in Las Vegas, they were basically allowing people with absolutely no flight experience to do parts in these test flights. And I mean, 25,000 successful test flights, that's a pretty impressive mile marker. So
it really is.
Okay, so next in the news, we have something unique about drones to the head.
Drones to the head? Oh my
God. People thought that every drone was a brick, and so if you get hit with this thing, it's really gonna hurt you. But we showed that that's just not the case. Industry's been very active with this data because to date, they haven't had real metrics from which they can do design and in which they can evaluate their vehicles.
Was that a karma?
To date, they haven't had real metrics.
Is that a karma?
Do design,
it,
very
is.
Active
it is. That is. That's a karma right there.
Because to date, they haven't had real metrics from.
Yep, that's that karma just doing its thing, crashing.
They wasn't even a test. They just accidentally filmed that.
Yeah, they just put out the call for drones. We need a drone to crash into someone's head, and the karma's like, "Hey, man, I think I just got a job." Yeah. Agent K, and then something Russian. $2 super chat. Thank you so much. Happy birthday, Ken. I think you're safe today, Jeff. I don't know what he's talking about.
Okay, so the Drone Champion League.
It's my birthday. I can do what I want. Back to you.
It's true.
He said it. He had to say it. If he hadn't said anything.
Right.
No super chat.
Right.
Yeah, it would have been fine.
They would have been. Great. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
All right. So, the Drone Champion League. Has introduced their official video game based off of their drone racing league type thing.
This looks pretty cool, man.
Now, this is based off of the idea that they're going to have, like, Formula One racing and drones.
Yeah.
The flying pig was cool.
Yeah, well, pigs are finally flying, so I guess this is possible, too. Wow.
Looks like it's going to be an impressive little application and probably be very beneficial for people that are, I guess, getting introduced to drones for the first time.
Yeah, and it'll help your FPVing skills.
I'm wondering, though, if you can use, like, your remote. You know how some of these apps will let you tie your remote to it? So
oh, like your FR Sky or whatever, just your regular controller? That'd be neat.
Yeah.
Cool.
Pretty neat.
Cool.
Yeah, that's cool.
It's cool. All right.
So next in the news we have
Man, hold the horses. Danny Lopez. $5 super chat. Woo! Happy birthday, Ken. Party like it's 1999. Woo!
Big Prince reference. Okay.
How old was I in 1999? Well, that was
20 years ago.
That was 20 years ago. I was 33. Wow. Just a whippersnapper.
Mm. Okay.
Yeah.
The acoustic drone project
Go ahead, Jeff. I'm just kidding. Go ahead.
The acoustic drone project is a new project that is designing an acoustic tool used to study marine animals. They're using drones to essentially drop an acoustic microphone in the water to be able to I guess, hear or to listen out for animals or mammals in the water. This is an example of them testing this. I think this is part of the third series that they did.
Okay. And they want to hear animals in the water?
Yeah, I mean, the acoustic microphone they can use to for, like,
oh, careful.
Sonic.
Careful, getting kind of low. Watch it. Mm. Watch it. Yep. Oh, no. No, no, no. No, what are you doing? Come on, buddy. No, no. Oh.
Oh.
Oh, wait, that was intentional, I think.
Oh.
Yeah, they are using the drones that can land in the water.
Okay. And when I first saw that, I went, oh, experiment over. Cool, man.
Yeah. Very cool. New technology. I love the idea for drones. So,
Media right, so Mike, $5 super chat. Goodness. Maybe one more bird? Nah, we can't do that to Jeff. Brad Wilson.
Oh, one more bird?
We can't do that to Jeff.
No, we can't. Brad Wilson, $25 super chat. Oh, my goodness. Brad, happy birthday. Thanks, buddy. Wow, that's cool. Thank you, Brad. Man, that's awesome. I got one more bird for you, Jeff. It's right here. What happened with that? Hide the kids.
You guys are bad. Mm. Okay, so recently they had, I guess, an interesting competition in Rwanda. They flew medical drones versus ambulances. They had a series of flights in which they took the drones up and they took blood samples to various locations, and the drones were able to carry the packages to the locations faster and more accurately than the ambulances were. something really kind of interesting to take into consideration as part of using drones with the medical industry.
Very good. And I hear that the Karma drone was involved in this as well, but it just didn't make it back yet.
Oh, man. All right. Last in the news, we have the Heisha, or Heisha. It takes flight as a fixed-wing vertical takeoff and landing capability. This thing is cool.
Okay. And what do we do?
This is a security system. It's like a Nest in your backyard. And it will work with various drones, such as DJI, Unique, PX4, etc. But what you do is you essentially can tell the drone where you want to fly. And it will then send a signal to your house, which you're not there, obviously.
Right.
And in this case, they have a Mavic set up. Now, the drone on the platform is always being kept charged. So the drone will then take off. It'll fly a route for the area that you want to survey or check to make sure that it's safe or that security is fine. And then what's nice is that it'll automatically land on the pad once it's completed.
Okay.
And then reconnect itself up and start charging again.
Oh, that's neat. Does it come with the bamboo frame? Because that's a nice little touch.
Yeah. That's a special offer there.
So I thought it was wireless charging like a cell phone, but it actually plugs itself in.
Yeah, I thought that was actually a pretty interesting design. When it first took off and the Mavic had all that stuff underneath it, I was thinking to myself, my God, that's a lot of weight.
Yeah, so. Now what happens? It's a cool idea, but what happens if it's flying around your property and it hits one of those things? What are those things called that walk? No, they fly and they have feathers.
A toddler.
Not a toddler. It's a thing. Jeff, you know what I'm talking about. It's one of those
bird.
Sorry. What is it?
It's a bird.
Is Jeff the most patient newsman in the history of news? Can you imagine Tom Brokaw doing the news with two knuckleheads interrupting him every 5 minutes?
Yeah, that would be funny.
Growing up as a child, I will tell you right now that I absolutely loved that song when I was a kid.
Oh, you did?
But I'm beginning to wear on me.
Now, you know what? As a reward for putting you through that, Jeff, isn't as a I'm sorry. What I'm going to do is I'm going to play the audio from me calling my mother at 4:04 a.m.
Yes, please.
And we're on the phone for about 10 minutes just talking about this or that. I edited it down to a more digestible size because I feel that the love that is going on in this call is just too much for you guys. It'll overwhelm you. Kelly.
Let's go.
All right.
I know what's coming.
So I was born at 4:04 a.m. on August 22nd, 1966 A.D. And so every year, as long as I can remember, I call my mom, and I thank her for being my mommy.
Happy birthday.
Hello, Mama.
Hey, happy birthday to my little baby boy.
It's your little baby 53-year-old boy.
How about that?
And this year, you know, in past years, I called at 4:04 my time, which was actually an hour too late. So
I know that.
But you didn't say anything because you're a nice mama.
Yes.
So I've been calling you for many years at 5:04 your time.
Yeah.
But it's I'm on Central and you're on Eastern. I did it right this time.
You did.
I'm a good little baby boy.
You're good little baby boy. Yeah, I was wondering this time if it was going to be, because I woke up about 15 minutes ago. And I thought, I wonder if I'm going to have to wait till 5:04.
Oh. Well, thank you for being my mommy.
Thank you for picking me to be your mommy.
I love you, Bobby.
I love you too.
Thank you.
Thoughts, Kelly? Thoughts?
I can't believe you were stone cold sober when you did that. You sound like you've had one or seven, but I know you well enough to know you do that every year, and that's how you talk to your mom. Anytime when we were doing our radio show and we'd have your mom on the show, that's how you would talk.
It's a little thing that we do because we do it for other people's benefit, especially Kelly, because Kelly just like,
I love you, Mom.
If you think I have patience doing the news, that woman is friggin' patient.
Ooh, you got that right.
I can't drive 55. This is just, this just in from Johnny FPV. Smoke him if you got him. $5, $49 super chat. I don't know what that means. What does that mean, Jeff? You have any idea what that means?
No, I have absolutely no idea what any of that means.
I think you do. Oh! Oh, yeah! Johnny FPV! Follow that car, man! You're a rebel! Smoke them if you got them! Yeah! Light it up! Light it up! Yes, sir! Show's off the rail for realsies now, yeah. Mm-hmm. All right, Jeff, thank you so much. We have to get back into our regular groove, but we really appreciate you. We do, apparently, and they're waiting. But thank you so much, Jeff.
Thanks for stopping by. Now get out!
Oh, my goodness. Boy, he has the patience of Job, doesn't he?
Do we have time for anything else?
We don't. No, I have so much stuff. We're gonna give away Free Will. We're gonna draw for the Jiyun Crane M2 gimbal tonight.
Nice.
And I got a bunch of great stories and video to share. But right now, as I bring in our first guest, who is Wolfgang Weber, here is Kelly Green with a joke.
Where do bees go to the bathroom?
Where?
At the BP station.
That's pretty good.
Yeah.
Alexa, tell me a joke.
Did you hear about the table that thought it was a rocking chair?
No.
It had a few screws loose.
I think he's here.
At the table that thought it was a rocking chair?
Yeah, no. You're going to have to turn down your thing there. Wolfgang, welcome to the show. I'm sorry that we're calling so late, but the fates decided to throw me a curveball for
30 minutes, Ken.
Yeah.
30 minutes late.
Yeah, I'm very sorry. Kelly, tell him how punctual I am, usually.
He's usually very punctual, if not early.
That's true. That's absolutely true. And I'm sorry to make you wait, but welcome to the show, man.
You're good. Yeah, no, thanks. Thanks for having me. You guys have been keeping me entertained.
Okay. Yeah. It's a weird night, and I have not been drinking. But I might start. I might start. So for those who don't know who you are, tell the people who you are, where you are, and what's happening with you.
For you guys that don't know me, my name's Wolfgang. I am a drone operator here in Los Angeles, California. Originally from Canada, and out here living that drone life.
And he's also an actor.
Okay, yeah, that I figured that's what you were trying to get at.
Yeah. Yes, and he's been on the TV, man. You want to see?
What show?
Oh,
what
lots show of. Check this out. Check this out.
Now you said you had a business dispute with Mr. Dutros.
No, not a dispute. He wanted the space to build condos. He's a developer, but because of our lease, he needed our agreement to sell.
This man's beef. Was it with the both of you or just one?
Both. We're 50-50. We own this together. And you know, he's so condescending. When he comes in here, he doesn't even know who is who. Why?
The epithet. Whore. It's singular. Mm-hmm. Like he was just addressing one of you.
That's good acting right there, man.
To trick you.
It's possible. Tricky with everything. And for you, madam. One labor-inducing pizza deluxe.
Does it work?
Absolutely. Five women have gone into labor after eating that pregnancy pizza.
Really?
Yeah.
Who the hell is this?
This is just a client, babe. Relax.
Client? What? BS.
It's Vanilla Ice.
Client. You know, I'm sick and tired of you
belittling me.
I guess someone. What do you call that character with the glasses?
Just so you all know,
that's my Ken Heron.
Ah, very good, man. Nice, nice, nice.
The demo. Yeah, that's a funny thing. True story is that I drone up all those movies.
You did?
Yeah, well, in a nutshell, I moved out to LA to be an actor, and things were going good. Obviously, I've done some shows, nothing too, I guess, mainstream. I've been on, you know, CSI Miami, Nip Tuck, stuff like that. And then I just kind of hit a brick wall like 5 years ago. I was on hold for a Jason Statham movie to play the lead, and it ended up going to Milo Ventimiglia. He's if you guys look at Milo, I think he got his start on that show Heroes.
And, oh yeah.
He ended up getting the role, and I ended up just, I didn't quit acting. I just kind of got rid of agents and managers and was kind of searching for what I enjoyed doing as a kid. And I went back into like RC stuff. And prior to acting, I was an engineering student, and I used to build RC cars, and my grandpa used to fly RC planes. My dad had RC boats. So I ended up buying a drone and just started uploading footage back in 2014 on Facebook. And then because I've already been in the industry, I was friends with directors, producers, and everything. They saw my footage, and then it kind of turned into like, hey, can you shoot this for me, this music video and this feature film? Do you have any stock footage of this? Do you have this? And then it just started snowballing into now a business. And
cool.
It pulled me out of the rest. I used to serve tables for almost a decade. It pulled me out of the like that world, and I've been self-employed.
It's a weird world, isn't it? To because everybody's an actor, right? Like everybody is trying to be an actor.
But it's great because it's all under the same umbrella. So when I told you that all those movies I was piloting, I was kind of using negotiating with producers and directors, just saying like, look, you know, you guys want drone shots, to get a drone team in here, it's going to charge you $3,000 to $14,000 a day. You know, I'll charge you a fraction of the price, put me in your movie. And they would literally just hand me the script, and they just said, you can't have the leads because offers are out, but what do you want? And I basically, if you go on like my IMDb page, it's like every movie I've been in, I've also been droning it.
Do you change costume when you do that, or are you flying the drone as a cop?
No. They just schedule it for set different days.
Oh, okay.
They schedule it for different days. So, it turned into this career. And I mean, you saw that one scene from Lifetime. I had that scene with Michelle Borth, and she's one of the leads on Hawaii 5-0. One of the other scenes there was from this girl, Inanna Sarkis. She's a big YouTube sensation, but. Yeah, so I still act. So I still audition. I just auditioned a couple weeks ago, and I still do it. But my day job is flying for film and television commercials.
And you work with Brennan at his company, too?
Yeah, well, Brennan and my relationship spawned, I'd say, a couple of years ago. We were both hired by Polar Pro to join their industry professional program for educational purposes. And we were both ambassadors for Polar Pro. They would send us equipment and stuff, and we'd make videos for it. And that's where I met Brennan. And Brennan actually, for the commercial that they were shooting to advertise this program, Brennan actually directed me. And at the end of shooting this commercial, I ended up exchanging information with Brennan, and we kind of like didn't really talk so much. And then when the new year came along, I reached back out. We met up for coffee, and we started flying. And I started flying with him, you know, under his company, Transit Pictures, and as you guys, he has Droner Tech on YouTube, but
yeah,
this friendship just kind of blossomed, and we've just been working. Literally, I usually pilot. Brennan, as you know, is a professional drone operator as well, but usually when we fly together, I pilot, he cam ops, because he loves the working the camera.
Yeah, Brennan is a unique character. He's the kind of guy who you want to be in his orbit. You know what I mean?
Yes.
Like, you want to get caught up in his gravity because he's just such a go-getter.
Oh yeah, and he knows what he wants. He knows how to direct things. And a lot of times, you know, when we shoot, he's like the communicator. He directs the shot, so he usually conversates with the director, and the director we'll tell him what he wants, and then we're on comms, and then you'll be like, okay, Wolfgang, I want you to go elevate to 150 feet. I want you to drop at this speed and come in on the car or whatever the subject is that we're tracking.
Kelly, did you have a question for him?
Yeah, two questions, Wolfgang, and they're both very personal.
Yeah.
Number one, is it really awesome or really awkward to kiss a girl in a television show or a movie?
Oh.
It's extremely awkward.
Really? Okay.
It depends. My wife's upstairs, but there's been a couple times where I was like, oh wow, this is my job.
Does your wife have any say? And like, you give her the script and go, there's a love scene in here. Is that okay, honey? Do you talk to her about that?
I mean, yeah, I tell her about it. There's times where but the thing is, like, most of the time when I'm booked in it for a scene or something like that, I'm usually not attracted to my co-star.
Right.
And I'm just like, okay, it's a job. But there are some times where you are like, you're like, oh wow, she's.
Don't say that. Don't say that. If you're like it here.
If I were single, she'd be in trouble. You know, one of those.
Oh man. So you have your SAG card, obviously, right?
Yes.
I mean, that's something that you get. Is that something? And what we're talking about is the Screen Actors Guild card, and this is something that you get after you get a speaking part. Is that correct?
You have to earn. You have to have like 3 speaking parts. It's really kind of a weird thing they have going. You have to have 3 speaking parts in a full SAG scale like production.
Ah.
And mine were. I did a movie with Kevin Spacey before the whole Kevin Spacey stuff went down.
Right.
Years ago for HBO, and it was a small part, but that was one. I did this one for Ace Ventura, that when they did the remake of Ace Ventura, but Jim Carrey wasn't in it. It was just supposed to be like his long lost son. I did that one, and CSI Miami was the last one that got me into the union.
That's cool, because you can get health insurance through that, can't you?
You can, yeah. But my wife's a teacher, so she has way better health care than what they have.
Yeah. Well, now let's get back to your drone stuff here. I've got a few clips. Sure. You did some work for an Adidas commercial. That's the one I'm going to play now.
Yeah. I shot that last year, and that was Kylie Jenner, Adidas. I believe it was Adidas Falcon, those shoes that you see there.
Yeah.
That was a night shoot. So there's a team of us. Brendan actually wasn't on that. I think he was probably busy, but that was my buddy Steve. He came up, I piloted, and then I had a VO because it was a night shoot, and it was pretty intense, actually.
How much footage will you shoot for something that lasts 3 or 4 seconds in the commercial? Like, how much will you have?
Usually what happens is that shoot was very tricky in particular because they were shooting out in San Bernardino, half of San Bernardino and half of Los Angeles County. So I had to do double the permitting work to do this job. And I asked production, I was like, can you guys not just shift the location a mile one way? It's the road's straight for miles. Why does it have to be right here?
Mm.
And production didn't budge. I was like, all right, because San Bernardino wanted a $2 million policy. LA County wanted a $5 million policy. So I was literally just pulling permits from 2 different counties just so they can drive that car you saw in that short second just across the county line. So
that's the thing that people don't realize is the amount of red tape and logistics that you have to do to shoot feature films and commercials and things like that, where there's a bunch of companies and insurance and actors and everything. I mean, you have to have like the fire department on scene, and you have to pay them. And that's why I think I remember you saying just a little bit ago, and I'm sure some people's jaws dropped when you said, I'll charge less than $12,000 because everybody, they're like, $12,000? I'm moving to California. But you have to pay all these people.
I feel like if I would have started now today, it would have been a lot harder. I think a lot of the reasons it was easier for me, I guess, easier, is because I was already in the industry.
Hmm.
So I already knew people to reach out to when I had this service. And during the time, it was new. No one was really flying drones unless it was like Aerial Mob or Cine Drones and any of those guys. Those were like the big heavy hitters. So as a little guy coming up in the industry, I was cutting people deals, and then I realized actually working with Brennan, Brennan who kind of opened my eyes to how to really make money. And that's when, you know, things started turning around, you know. And then, yeah, but yeah, that's why we spend hours and hours with paperwork. And any drone company or guy working or watching this right now, like, you know, you can spend a couple hours. It's not just insurance, it's permits, it's your FSO is going to want to know the plan of activity. So you got to create a spreadsheet, not a spreadsheet, you got to create like your operation, basically. Mm-hmm. Where are you going to fly? How are you going to be? What are you doing? And there's a lot of paperwork involved in doing it, but it can be lucrative, you know, but it's
right. But
it's
all that stuff, does that take any of the fun out of it and turn it into just a task?
It does sometimes, because, you know, that Adidas spot was 30 seconds, you know, and it's that's not another side of the game, is that you got to negotiate, because, you know, when people are trying to, you know, hire you and you tell them like, oh, I'm going to fly for $4,000, you know, and they're like, well, it's only a half day and we only need a couple shots. Mm-hmm. But come on, if I book your job and I charge you $2,000, I can't work any other job that day. I actually just had a conversation about that tonight, and people just want deals. So if what happens is, I learned the hard way, you end up giving them a deal, you charge them half, it ends up turning out to be a 10-hour day, and they want more shots. Because what's going to happen, and you launch that drone, director and producers are behind you, they're on monitor, they're gonna be like, oh well, since you got it up, can you get this shot too, can you do this, and you end up shooting 480 gigs of Cinema DNG 5.2K raw, you know, and then you gotta wait 2.5 hours for the drop, because you don't want to leave them your $900 cards, right?
Right. What are you filming with? What are you using?
We primarily shoot with the Inspire 2, but I mean, I've flown Altas and M600s, but primarily DJI products for the most part.
Okay. Something else here that, now this was an Emmy winner, and it had Mario Andretti in it.
Oh yeah, that's one of my favorite projects.
The Magnaflow. And I've cut it down to just the part that you were involved with. Maybe you can talk a little bit about that. Did you get to meet Mario Andretti, or is that a different day for Mario?
It was a different day. I just got to meet, like, just the actors involved.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, here is the sequence that you were involved with.
Oh, yeah.
Cars.
This is one of the first projects Brennan and I actually worked together on. He came up, I piloted.
I remember when Brendan was on a few times ago, he sent me some raw footage of you're flying the drone for this.
Yeah.
You're trying to protect it, but man, I'm
not
eating anything on the table.
That's not us.
Just
you can see drone shots very quick, right?
Right.
Very quick shots. That's us, obviously. Uh-huh. That's us. That's us.
What kind of coordination do you have to do to get, like, you know, the ground shots to match the aerial shots and resolution and treatment and everything? Like, is there a standard what they're asking for?
Usually you have that conversation right away on set. You meet the DP who's going to be on the ground, and you just ask them, hey, what are you shooting? What do you want us to shoot? You tell us, you direct us what you want, and we'll get you whatever you want. So we have that dialogue. Either Brennan or I will go up to a DP and just, look, do you want to shoot 4K, 5.2K? I believe that shoot, they wanted specifically the X7 because they wanted, I think, 6K or 6K raw. And so that they wanted the fullest, highest resolution. And I believe because it's cinematic, they wanted the 2398 frame rate. We just get all the logistics off of them.
Okay.
And just the match. So what's your white balance at? And all the logistics of like what they want, just so it's easier to match, basically.
Cool. I have one more video here, and it's from a rapper called Pusha T, I guess. I'm not familiar.
Pusha T, yeah.
I'm not familiar with Pusha T. He's not in my iPad. But
I didn't know who he was either. So I was hired just to fly a drone around his head.
Yeah. Well, I'm not gonna play the song just because I don't know if I have enough bleeps. So what I did was I went ahead. And I grabbed a production rap song, and hopefully it matches up a little bit, but it still shows your drone footage. So here that is.
What you gonna do with all that?
See, it doesn't match, does it? But wait, wait, wait for it. See, how's the finger part? That matched.
Good.
Yeah. So, how long did this take?
We were there. That was another, I'm telling you, this happens a lot. That's another one of those jobs where they only want you for a few hours and a few shots, and it turns out being a 12-hour day.
And it was a closed road and all that?
Yeah.
Because you had to go back and forth a lot?
They closed everything down, and we were just flying Phantom 4s. The director had this idea of making a Phantom 4 to pretend to act like a drone, police drone. So they rigged this Phantom 4 out. They put, like, lights on it. They put, like, police on it. And they hired me to fly. They had another drone, so my buddy Steve was on that one, and he flew and got the drone on the drone. And I was just basically looking in the monitor, the director's monitor, just making sure, like, I wasn't going to hit him in the head, because they wanted to just, as he was wrapping towards the camera, when he went this way, I had to go that way and vice versa.
Oh.
So I'm literally just going back and forth behind him.
Kelly, you look like you want to chime in.
Has your biggest payday come from flying a drone or acting, and how much was it?
Ooh, good question.
That's, come on.
And what is your exact weight and your PIN number?
And is Wolfgang a stage name?
You don't have to answer any questions if you don't want to.
I would say, definitely droning. I've made a lot more money droning than I have acting.
And that's because you've done more droning, right? That doesn't say anything bad about your acting.
No. I mean, you kind of get the idea. Like, acting, it's very, there's literally millions and millions of people. There's 9 million people out here. It's a numbers game, you know? And I was playing the numbers, and I was getting more success using my agent, my drone as an agent, than I was having an agent as an agent. So I was using that as
right.
leverage.
Hey, you got to do what you do. You know, acting is a very, you've done a lot. For, you know, done more than most people will ever do. And so that's good.
And the thing is, like, I think what it is now is I'm approaching it differently. So I'll probably end up producing, directing something at some point. But to answer your question, there was a drone job. I won't name the job, but there was one thing where it was 14 grand for the day.
Wow.
Ooh, snap.
Woo, where's that help?
Taking pictures.
Just stills. Wow, cool.
We were flying, if you guys follow me on Twitter, you'll figure it out what it was, but we were just taking billboard pictures for a billboard, and it was using the Hasselblad. We were flying a Hasselblad on an M600.
Okay, excellent.
So, well, yeah, it was pretty good money.
Now, you're a jack of all trades, and one of the trades that you do part-time is you work for one of my favorite companies of all time, X Dynamics, and I still have a hat.
Put on that hat, Ken. There you go.
How's it look over the headphones? Pretty good?
Yeah, it looks great.
Yeah. But we were talking a little bit before about this, and I do have to say, if you remember my experience with X Dynamics, it wasn't the most positive video that I've ever done, but hats off literally to X Dynamics for stepping up and coming back on the show and explaining, you know, what was what. And I have nothing but respect for them.
I like everyone. I love the whole team over at X Dynamics. You were talking to Maury, I believe, but everyone was great. I started as just a content creator, so I was just a content creator for them earlier this year, and then I started working with them part-time, continuing creating content and testing out drones and giving feedback and stuff, and that's kind of where I've been at for the last few months.
Okay.
And yeah, so they got a few tricks up their sleeve. They're going to be releasing some cool things coming up, and I mean, I can't obviously talk about it,
right,
but I was at the office yesterday, and They got some cool stuff coming.
Well, I'm looking forward to it. I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, for sure. They're a good group of guys.
Yeah. Now, the show was kind of derailed, so we're running late. I do apologize to John Smithers. We're going to talk to him in just a moment. But before we do a thing with all our guests every week called Would You Ride It? And it's usually these contraptions that people are making in their backyards that will use some sort of weird thing to make them fly. Some drone type thing. And this is one of the...
Would I ride it?
Yeah, the question is, would you ride it? If this machine was handed to you, would you get on it or in it or under it and ride it? And this one is one of the weirdest I've ever seen. And I'm going to say, I'm a hard no on this. And I don't know if I've shown this before, but it's worth another view. Check this out. Let me know in the chat. By the way, quick thank you to Jason Blanton. I know that went by a while ago. $5 super chat. He says, happy birthday, my Leo bro. Did I miss any more super chats, Kelly? Any more?
I can't drive 55. No, you're up to date.
Okay, good. And now...
Happy birthday, by the way, Ken.
Oh, thanks, man. How old of a guy are you?
I'm 36.
36. Already a Hollywood star.
Oh,
where,
yeah.
Where have I gone wrong? Would you ride it? Check this out.
All right.
What?
Yeah.
No way.
Yeah, I'm a no on that.
No.
Let me know in the chat. I don't know what kind of seat he's got, but it doesn't look comfortable.
It doesn't look comfortable. Yeah. No way.
So,
I don't see why people don't like put prop guards on any of these things.
Right? Right?
There's no prop guards. Even on the one that had the 25,000 flights that was in the news, there's no prop guards. Yes, you're enclosed, but you just don't know.
Well, prop guards way too much, man.
I get it, but still.
Looked like he had a giant GoPro Karma on his head.
It did.
Know, right?
Gary H. says, no! And Ken says, oh, hells yeah. Ken Lagoe says, hells yeah. Paul Dovine says, insane, no way. I'm getting a lot of no's. Yeah, Mel says,
no, I wouldn't.
Mel says, no effing way. Thanks, Mel, for being classy. So you're a no on that?
Yeah, I'm a definite no. I would not fly that now. My arms, my limbs, my head are very, very precious to me.
Yes. And Kelly?
No,
I didn't even have to ask you. Oh. Okay. Well, Wolfgang, before I let you go, tell us, yes, since you're good buddies and I know he's watching, tell us one thing about Brennan that no one knows.
Oh, God. I didn't, you, believe it or not, Brennan's a very secretive person, and he doesn't actually say, he doesn't let too much out.
Okay, let me rephrase that. Wolfgang, make up something about Brennan that no one would believe.
Brennan's just overly confident.
He really is, isn't he? And it's kind of contagious. You know, when you're around him, you feel empowered.
Oh, yeah. No, he definitely has that vibe. I think that's honestly why we work really well together, is because it's contagious. So when we're on a job, if someone tells us to do something, it's, you know, fly this, fly between here, go between these doors or whatever it is. It's, we're always like, yeah, sure, whatever. What do you want? Let's do it.
Brendan, you think we can do it? Yeah. Okay, then it can be done.
Yeah,
awesome.
Sure.
Well, there's a link in the description to all Wolfgang's social media and stuff. I urge you to check it out and subscribe and follow and do all that stuff. Wolfgang, thank you so much for being on with us.
Thanks for having me, guys.
Appreciate it.
And if you have any other questions, if anybody has questions with the drone industry or anything, just, you know, let me know. You guys know how to find me.
Awesome. Thank you, sir.
Awesome. Thank you, guys.
All right. We'll see you.
See ya.
All right. Well, he was cool, wasn't he?
I like that guy. I could have asked him a million questions.
Yeah, he had a lot. I mean, he's just, anybody that's friends with Brennan is probably going to be the coolest.
Yeah.
And now, I want to go ahead and call John, but before I do that, I'm going to play this amazing footage that John Smithers caught. Now, you know, it's all about being in the right place at the right time with your drone, and this footage that he got, he'll explain more about it, but he's been hounded by these clip companies that post these clips. I think it's Viral Hog and all these things. You know, you get something cool and post it on YouTube, somebody's going to want to charge somebody money for it. And I just reached out to him and said, hey, man, can I show it on the show? And he's like, yeah. How about Skyping? I'm like, yeah. So he's a pretty cool guy to let me share this with you. And so I'm going to just go ahead and show this and let you be amazed. This is an Inspire 2. And he was just filming the cliffs. I forget the name of them, but he'll let us know. And then look on the right. He was coming up, and then something caught his eye. What is going on over there?
Oh, wow.
The cliffs are collapsing. And I don't know if you can see it in this gorgeous 1080, but there are kayakers right there.
Oh, my. Look at that.
And they just happened to be at that point of the cliff, and he just happened to be flying at that point when all that happened. Can you imagine an EKG on those kayakers? I mean, I would be just paddling for my dear life.
Right. If they had been 50 feet, 100 feet the other way, they'd been in trouble.
Yeah. So.
Wow.
Yeah. Gorgeous footage. So let me go ahead and bring in our buddy John Smithers, which is just a cool name. Yeah. Those are some lucky kayakers for sure.
Where was that? Where was that? What state was that in?
Well,
happy birthday, Jim.
Oh, thanks, man. Appreciate it. There he is. There's John. Welcome to the show, buddy. Kelly was asking where did this happen? And what is the name of those cliffs?
That is Pictured Rocks National Lakeshore.
Okay. And where is that? What state?
That is in Upper Peninsula, Michigan.
Okay. So tell us just ever so briefly, what happened? What were you doing? And how did you feel when those kayakers almost got smashed?
We were doing some video for Craig Blacklock's new book. And we were panning the bluff and getting ready to, and we heard a loud explosion. And so I turned my drone right and saw debris, and the kayakers were there, and it looked like they were okay. So we turned back towards the bluff, and we're going to pan it again. And out of the right side of the screen, I could see it collapsing and heard a louder explosion. And so we turned the drone right away and started heading down there. We heard screams. We're 3/4 of a mile away on a pontoon boat, and you don't hear anything 3/4 of a mile, but we could hear screams, you know.
You could hear the people in the kayak screaming.
Yeah. And you got two girls there that really had a set of lungs, you know.
Wow. And how often does this piece of land calf like this?
It's not that rare. It's rare to get it on film or video.
Right.
It's not readily available. One of the kayakers, one of the guides down there, got video from it down below. And you can hear him in the video say, oh, fuck.
Yeah, well, we like to talk about trucks. Right, Kelly? Oh, boy, we like trucks. Boy, how do we like those trucks? Right, kids? Oh, we love those trucks. I would probably talk about those trucks, too, if I was right there when that happened. Oh, John, you're going to be a rascal, aren't you? This footage you posted where? And how did companies find this? Because you Viral Hog and all these people have been hounding you about this.
That night, we called TV6 out of Marquette, Michigan. And so we gave them a link to it, and they agreed to pay some money. And they said they had some small, you know, following on online media. And so we posted it. Gosh darn, by the next morning, we had 100,000 hits.
Wow.
Just from that. And we were getting calls from all over the world. Spain and the Netherlands and Weather Channel, NBC, CBC, CBS, CNN, all of them.
And has that settled down now?
Oh, yeah. It's like...
Yeah. When did this happen? How long ago was this?
This was Monday before this last.
Okay. Kelly, did you have a question?
Yeah. You mentioned that there was an explosion. Was the explosion the sound of the cliff collapsing, or was there a separate explosion that caused the cliff to collapse?
Well, I mean, when the rocks break away, I mean, and that's where we heard this. It wasn't hitting the water or falling. It was breaking away from the cliff. That where we heard the sound, because you could see I got the whole thing. I turned it before it hit the water. So
gotcha.
And no, there was no dynamite or anything involved, you know.
Yeah, I'm thinking it was probably a government conspiracy.
Yeah.
That's what I'm thinking.
Actually, it was probably just a little ant just pushed the grain of sand just a little bit too hard.
Right.
And everything was set up for failure, you know.
You know, there's probably some worms or, I don't know, rats or mice in there going, "What's going on here?" and then they're
yeah. I bet you. There was a trail up top there too, you know, so we had to check that out. We had to survey the whole situation and make sure nobody was hurt. Our biggest concern was people's safety, especially with the screams. So we got over there right away.
You can see the road. There's a little road path or something. Somebody could have been walking right there.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Wow. There's a trail there.
Wow.
Well, that's definitely where people have stepped out to look, you know, and that's where they shouldn't, you know. I mean, it's going to cause people to be a little safer. You know, I mean, not a lot of people die from this, but, you know, maybe we could save one life, you know.
Right. That, at that height, I mean, that's not a height that you could jump off and land in the water and live. That's
200.
Yeah, that's too high. But so there's links in the description of this video, this stream, to John's stuff and the book and everything. And if you want more information, there's a link to a video that where you were interviewed and you explain a lot more than we have time for today.
The whole story.
Yes. Well, thank you for being on. Thanks for being patient with our false start, and I really appreciate you letting us use the video.
I enjoyed the show.
Awesome. Thank you, sir, very much. Have a good one.
You bet. Thank you. You too.
All right. Bye-bye. Bye. Well, now, things are going a little bit more smoothly right now.
How come my drone never flies at the right place at the right time like his drone does?
That's because it was made by GoPro.
Oh, that's right. Yes.
Yeah, you keep forgetting that.
Yep.
All right. So, now, it's time to talk about something that we should have talked about earlier, and that is RemotePilot101.com. We love RemotePilot101.com, and you should too. If you want to get your Part 107 certification from the FAA, I'm going to call it the FAA from now on.
Does anybody like that?
They don't like it? It's the FAA, or as I like to say, the FAA. You can go to remotepilot101.com, put in Heron18, get 30% off. Jason Shepard is the instructor. Here is the site right here. So sign up and you can learn everything that you need to know to pass the FAA test. Says it right there, FAA, UAS. If you wanna pass the FAA UAS test,
you pay one price and you got the course for life, because obviously your license is only good for 2 years. You're probably going to have to brush up a little bit a couple of years later. So you want to make sure you can go back and not pay again. And that's the way it is. One price, you got it for life.
That's right. And they're always updating things. If a new rule comes out, they will include it in the curriculum and you can take quizzes right after. It's all video based. It's easy peasy. And I'm not a good test taker. I'm just not. But I was retaining the information in this course.
And they have actual, don't tell anybody this, but they have actual questions from the test in the course.
Yeah, there are some tricky questions. So use remotepilot101.com, sign up again, Heron18, and you'll get 30% off. And Jason Shepard will be at Spin Up in Austin on October 19th. So
have you ever met Jason? Is he a nice guy?
I haven't met him in person, but he's been on the show a few times.
Yeah.
A couple of super chats. I don't want to forget. Jerry, Drone Obsessed. A little birthday cake. $1.50. Thank you very much, Jerry. And Sean Barnhill. Happy birthday, Ken. It's my birthday, too. Hey, happy birthday to you, Sean. Very good. Did I miss any more? Oh, Place It Here. $10 super chat. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Ken. Happy birthday to you. Ooh.
Wow.
Now, there was someone that watches this stream all the time that actually recorded himself wishing me a happy birthday. Nope. Can you guess who that is?
Dana Williams.
It's Kelly Green. And go. Mm.
Happy birthday, Ken. Would you like me to sing for you?
Nope.
All right, back to you.
I really don't. Kelly is the worst singer ever. I'm trying to find this. Oh, here it is. It's from Art Carlson. You know Art. Here he is. Thank you so much, Art. This is awesome.
Hey, Ken, this is Art Carlson over here at Artco Drone Solutions. I want to wish you a happy birthday. So here it goes. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Ken. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Ken.
It's Ken Dollar.
And bye.
Thank you so much, Art. That's wonderful.
Are there Ken Heron action figures I didn't know about?
I don't know about action figures, but there are dolls.
Oh, dolls. Okay.
Yeah. Now,
I don't want that.
Now, speaking of dolls, tell the people what kind of dolls you have. Kelly has a whole closet full of dolls.
This is so random. We're not even on this topic right now. We've got videos to get to. We've got people to talk to.
You're right.
Let's move along.
You're right. You're right. You're right. Let's get to our first video, and maybe you can explain to us what the hell is going on here. Is that you? That is. That's Kelly Green.
That's me in the white shirt. Watch this.
Oh, yeah. Where is this?
At the Henry County Fair.
Boom! Clothesline! Wow. Wow. So, a lot of people don't realize, but Kelly Green is a wrestling fan. He is a grown man and he likes wrestling. And I tease him about it because, and I don't mind saying that wrestling is ridiculous.
Oh.
Oh.
I'm going this Sunday in Nashville, Tennessee.
Are you really?
I've got ringside front row seats and I'm pumped, pumped.
Are you really?
Yes, I'm going, brother.
Okay. Okay. If you like wrestling, hey, that's fine and that's okay. But it's just that Kelly likes wrestling. I'm not okay with. If you like wrestling, that's fine. I'm good with it. But Kelly liking wrestling, meh. It's so weird. He's got a closet full of dollies.
Dude.
Yeah.
Action figures.
Are they small representations of the human form?
Yes.
Then they're dolls.
Go!
So I'm going to say some wrestling names, and you tell me if they're cool, if you've met them, okay?
Met them or if they're cool?
Both. Eric Young.
Eric Young is cool. I've never met him.
Okay. Hulk Hogan.
Hulk Hogan is not cool. I've never met him.
Okay. Sting.
Sting is cool. I talked to him on the phone during an interview when I was in radio.
Would you like to see?
Oh, and somebody lifted the audio and posted it on their YouTube channel, and it's got like 100,000 views. Just the audio.
Wow. Would you like to see your? Would you like to see your buddy Ken meeting all three of those people?
What? Yes.
Yes, and in this, I'm about 50 pounds heavier, and I have a green beard, This is from an old morning show, and we were growing beards, and the loser had to color their beard. It was a weird show. Anyway, here's me meeting some wrestlers at Impact Wrestling.
Hey, all right, there's Vision Sting.
Hey, Sting, right here, right here. And standing next to us is the Invisible Man.
Oh, yeah.
That's right.
How's that working out?
Invisible Man.
So intimidating.
I am the stronger part of this trio here.
That's right.
Okay.
That's right.
Notice I'm not talking to fish. I'm talking to the invisible. I suggest you do.
There's a new character on the scene. They call him the Vacuumer. And he sucks up the competition. Don't you dare mess with the Vacuumer. It's his nemesis, the Mopper. Will they tangle tonight? We just don't know.
The Mopper!
Everything's manly here.
Impact Wrestling.
Yeah.
Cupcakes. The size of a thumb.
It's a manly, manly cupcake.
Look at that manly cupcake. Ooh!
And there's Hulk Hogan in the corner reading his script.
Is that really Hulk Hogan?
Yep. And there's me and Eric Young. Eric Young was very nice. Hulk Hogan was standoffish. He wouldn't even talk to us. But I was in the same room breathing his exhaled oxygen.
So you were that close to him and he wouldn't even talk to you?
No. We were just radio guys. Who cares about a couple radio guys?
Yeah. I'm not a fan.
Yeah. So anyway, it's been like 2 hours. We haven't shown any drone footage. How about we do that?
Okay.
Okay. The first one I want to share, this is from Joe Acassieri. And he says, Ken, I did this video on the Cape Cod Canal. The ship is called the Oliver Hazard Perry. Enjoy. I don't miss a Thursday ever. So this is a sailing ship from Joe Acassieri. And I'm just going to go ahead and say, I think he's ship for brains.
Hey!
It's a good video. Check it out. You ever been aboard one of these older or recreations of older vessels?
Only at a amusement park where it's swinging back and forth.
Yes, me too. No, I've been on a real wooden ship like this, an older one. I love tangible history like that. You can see all the wood cuts and the chisels and all that. Took quite a bit to build these things without the old Black & Decker drill and everything. Electric saws.
That's craftsmanship.
Yep. Did you say craftsman ship?
Yes. Hey.
Look at that. Silhouetted against the sky.
Wait a minute. I think that ship is cheating. The sails are down and it's moving at about 100 miles an hour. Has it got an engine on board?
Good point on that. Good point. I didn't even notice that. It's probably one of those repros.
It's got a trolling motor.
Wouldn't it be funny? You look at a sailing ship. It's got a big, huge paddle wheel in the back. That's something you never see, right? Thank you for sending that in. Good shot there, Joe Cassieri. We're going to share more videos. But first, should we give something away?
Nope.
Okay. What do you want to do then?
We got a super chat from Shane McQuillan. Hey! Happy birthday, Ken.
Thank you, Shane. All right. Maybe Shane wants to give something away.
I'm sure he does. Let's do it.
Shane, you want to give something away? Yes, I want to give something. Okay.
It's another exciting contest.
Wonderful. All right. I want to thank Freewell for being a sponsor tonight as well. And now is your chance to win some Freewell 4K all day ND filters for any of your devices, whether it be a DJI something or other, or something or other something. You just, if you win, then you tell me what the something is and they'll get it to you, all right? So the question for tonight, and by the way, please put it in live chat because top chat will skip some chats and there might be controversy. So make sure you have it in live chat. Okay, so here's the question. First correct answer in the chat will win some filters from Freewell. There are all kinds of filters. ND filters, pool filters, even the band filter. So, what year did the first filtered cigarette come out? And what was the brand? So you have to have those two things. What year was the first filtered cigarette released and what brand?
First correct answer in the chat. Wins and builders.
Is that bad? That's bad. I shouldn't have done that. I'm sorry for the dude out there that has one. It's bad. Anyway.
All right, I'm checking the chat.
Okay.
Wow.
It looks like maybe not the company, but we need the cigarette brand.
Going so fast.
I can tell you that they were sponsored by the Flintstones. The Flintstones did. You remember that?
Yep. Gregory Hurst, maybe? I think he's the first one.
Okay. We'll say Gregory Hurst. Congratulations. I'll go back and double check. Of course, remember.
The decision of the judge is final. Unless we change our mind.
Congratulations. You get some filters from Freewell.
If, 1954 Winston.
Yes, it was 1954 in Winston. And back when the Flintstones were black and white, they did a commercial for them. It's really kind of creepy to watch now. So, how about you want to see a drone crash?
Nope.
Okay.
Show it!
Okay! This is from Droning Harry. And he says, hey, Ken, this is a video from David Knight. It ends sadly and, as always, is an example to all of us about flying around bridges and water. I did reach out to the owner slash creator to get permission to share this footage. As always, your pal, Droning Harry. So let's not look at this as someone crashing their drone. Let's look at it more of someone just getting a new submarine. Let's glass half full. So here it is. Someone getting a new submarine. So we're going towards the bridge. It says entry. That's where drones go. So we're heading in. Should be a simple flight right through. But they did make one mistake. Can you guess what that mistake was?
They crashed.
Okay, they made two mistakes. What was the mistake they made right before the second mistake?
Their drone did not have obstacle avoidance.
Well, close. They left obstacle avoidance on. If you're going to do something like this, turn obstacle avoidance off, believe it or not.
Really?
Yeah, because what ended up happening was it got trapped under there. And when it gets trapped, what does it do? It goes up. Because it thinks there's a obstacle. So listen, you can hear it. So it thinks there's nowhere to go but up. And
No.
Oh man, that's sad, isn't it?
I learned something. I didn't know that you should turn off obstacle avoidance for something like that. I thought, okay, you got obstacle avoidance, you're going to slide right through.
Right. If you're going to go through a cave or something like that, make sure to have that off and make sure to fly straight. Thank you very much, Harry, for sending that in.
The GoPro Karma does not have obstacle avoidance. If I tried that, I probably would have got a compass error and it would have crashed immediately.
Yes, but one of the things that the GoPro Karma does have is purchasing avoidance. See, what you could have done, though, see, that's on all the time. when it's on the shelf, it has purchasing avoidance on, but it didn't work on you. If somebody else in the chat, if anybody else watching has a GoPro Karma, first, I'm sorry. Second, if you're willing to admit it so Kelly doesn't feel like he's the only one.
I like being the only one.
Do you?
Brother.
Okay. All right. Look, I know I trash it all the time, but here is a new video from Kelly using the GoPro Karma, right?
Yes.
So Kelly works for Premier Realty. Nice graphic, by the way.
Thank you.
Industrial Light and Magic?
No.
Okay. This is right down the street from our old location, the radio station.
Yeah.
And you used your drone to open the gate, right? So this is the Carroll County Thousand Acre Recreational Lake. That is the name of it. And you're filming lots? Is that what you're doing?
Yeah, we've got a lot. We listed a lot there on the water.
So lot 16. It's difficult to portray a lot in good light, isn't it? I mean, you did a good job.
It was perfect that day. This was yesterday. The sun was just so perfect yesterday.
Oh, you did this yesterday?
Yeah.
Wow. It is a pretty lake. So they're going to fill up all the lakeside stuff out there pretty soon, you think, Kelly?
Man, I hope so. Everybody that's got an acre wants to sell it right now.
Yeah, they do. Are you still nervous flying over water?
No, not at all.
Okay.
No. I never get nervous now with the Karma, because it's a Karma. If I crash it, oh well.
Are you secretly hoping it goes?
I wouldn't be sad if it did.
Nice backward shot there.
Thanks.
Yeah. So, as you can see, it is possible to get some good footage with the GoPro Karma. But I'm still going to make fun of it incessantly.
It's a disaster.
How do you feel, Kelly, and other people? As people from Australia, if you're watching, let me know what the rules are on messing with animals in your country. Because this is a pretty cool video, but in certain parts of the world, it would be illegal. And so this is from Malice Vex. And he says, I'm going to try an Australian accent. Forgive me. I can. I got told you would love this clip. Cheers, mate. Shrimp. Barbie. Not a knife. That kind of thing. So this is him using an FPV drone to chase kangaroos. It's awesome. But I'm wondering what the rules are about this. I'll show it anyway. I don't care.
Here we are today at this awesome spot. Some trees to play with. And just over yonder, we've got about 40, 50 kangaroos. Let's have some fun.
That's the fakest accent I've ever heard.
So, do they farm kangaroos or are they just running wild like that? Are kangaroos a farmable animal? Do people eat them?
I don't think so, do they? I don't know.
Maybe. Someone has.
Really?
Someone has eaten a... I'm sure. Yeah. Hey, haven't you had a roux burger? Come on, mate. Throw another roux on the barbie.
Ben Cartwright says yeah, they are like deer over here.
Like deer, okay. So... are we allowed to harass deer with drones?
Yes.
Cool. I don't think you should, but maybe they're his kangaroos. And they just look like they would kick your ass if you got near them.
Yes. Look at that dude is huge.
The muscles. And they wouldn't do it with their upper short little Tyrannosaurus Rex arms. They would bop you in the face with their back legs, man.
Yeah, with those big clown feet.
The big clown feet. They bounce on that back tail and then they just whoop it up with them feet.
Yeah.
Wow. It's a cool video though, isn't it?
It really is, yeah.
Very good. Very good. Thank you very much for sending that in. Malice Vex, if you would like to send something in, you can. KenHeronUpload@gmail.com. You can send it in there, or you can send me something to my new address, Ken Heron, P.O. Box 1281, Huntington, Tennessee, 38344. What else you been up to, Kelly?
It has been so busy. The last 2 months, it's just been nonstop. In the last 8 days, I've done 7 drone projects. I've posted 7 different drone videos to our Premier Realty Group YouTube page.
Oh, my gosh. Well, that's good. Yes?
Busy. Yeah, that's good.
But it's real hot outside. It's not a...
It has been so hot. It's been 95 this week and a heat index of about 106.
Oh, my gosh. Well, I'll be hanging out here in the air conditioning while you're out there flying, crashing your Karma. So man, we're going to do 1 second song later on. But first, and that is coming up in just a moment. But here's some more wonderful video from our buddy Ron Lockwood. Do you remember Ron Lockwood? He was our viewer visit a while back.
Yeah, he was our viewer visit.
Yeah, he was. He's from South Dakota. And yeah, very funny. He's a paramedic from South Dakota. He says, "Hey, Ken, hope all is well. If you recall, your story of your accident 2 years ago is how we began conversing. This is just a short video of heading out on a mission this week at work." He flies for a med flight. "I decided to test the Osmo Action and see how well it would hold up with the vibrations of the helicopter. Wanted to share it with you and hope this is one ride you never have to take again. Your paramedic friend from South Dakota, Ron Lockwood." So enjoy this. It's pretty cool. Let's ride the helicopter with Ron. The state preparedness. That's not it.
Center is designed for. I remember her.
Yeah, she's pretty cool too. Here it is. You ever ride a helicopter, Kelly?
Only once, when I was probably 6 or 7 years old. Our neighbor up the street actually owned one and landed it in a field over close to our house and took me for a 5-minute ride.
And it was pretty cool, wasn't it?
It was awesome, yeah.
I rode in a police helicopter once for a morning show. But I guess they have to walk around to make sure everything's cool before they get in. That's what he's doing here. So he's playing some kind of game there while he should be flying.
Candy Crush?
Candy Crush. Candy Crush. I really do admire paramedics of all sort. It takes a special kind of person to want to put yourself into those situations where people are having the worst days of their life.
Yeah, for sure.
Very cool.
Nice.
Yes. Thanks, Ron, for sending that in. Appreciate it. So what do you want to do now, Kelly?
You want to give something else away? You want to do more videos? You want some wacky jokes? You want some hilarious hijinks? What do you want?
I want some hilarious hijinks.
You want some hijinks?
Yeah. Give me the hijinks for my birthday.
Your birthday?
Hijink me.
So now's my time to sing? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, go ahead.
One, two, three. Happy birthday.
Okay, that's enough. You. Fantastic. And now, let's go ahead and play 1 second song, shall we? Yeah.
It's a song. It's a song. It's a 1 second song. So it's way too short for you to try to sing along. It's a song. It's a song. It's a 1 second song. Take a guess and see if you're right or wrong. It's a song. It's a song. It's a 1 second song. You can win a prize made in Hong Kong.
All right, so I have to use the program that knocked out our sound before. Hopefully, people can still hear us. People can still hear us? Yes? Is the audio still on?
I hope so. So far, so good.
Okay, so far, so good. For realsies, though, let me know in the chat. Can you still hear us? I'm so worried about this.
Yes.
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 Pickle says yes. Yep. Okay, good. All right. So, 1 second song this week will be songs that you and I are very familiar with because they are songs from the 90s.
90s?
Yeah, and these are songs from the early 90s that we used to play on the radio.
Ugh.
Yes, and they are some hard... You remember that whole era? I don't know, it was from like 94 through 7 where everything was... You know?
So and they were usually a duo, and they had a female lead singer.
Yes, yes. And it had... No matter what the song, it had some female in the back going, yeah, right? Well... Buckle up, because that's what we're doing. All right?
All right.
This first one, I think you'll get it. By the way, are we playing for someone? We have to play for someone. All right, so let me know who we're playing for.
Pick me in the chat. Pick me.
Pick me, and the prize will be...
Oh.
Oh, I got something perfect.
What is it?
This is from Chris Rollins' channel. This is a t-shirt that I ordered from his channel, from his t-shirt thing, and I ordered a large, and I guess this is a large from another country where people aren't that large. And I should have ordered like a 2X or something. So this
I love the t-shirt though.
Yeah, it's FPS, fun per second, made up by your pal Ken. So we'll play for the shirt. So pick me. Who are we playing for?
You're playing for Crash Freely. Crash Freely. And I think I spelled it wrong. I think it's F-R-E-H-L-E-Y.
Crash Freely. As in Ace Freely? Nobody gets that reference. Okay. Ace Freely? You don't... Kelly, do you know that? Okay. Yeah. All right. So here is your first 1 second song. Name this song, Kelly. I know you know it. Anybody in the chat get it? This may be an off week for Kelly. Yes, Ace Frehley is the drummer for Kiss. Yeah.
One more time.
Do you want me to help you?
Yes, please.
It's the first song that used auto-tune in a special way for so it goes. I can no?
Patchy Drizzle says shared. Good job, Patchy Drizzle.
It is share, yes. But Kelly didn't get it, so.
Sorry, so Crash Freely.
Sorry. Okay. This is a song that I used to play in the clubs when I DJed in the clubs. And there's a beginning part that every single radio station would cut out. Songs were sent to us either on CD or I guess they were sent to us on CD. It's the only way. And we would cut this part out of it, but I'll play the whole thing. It's like 10 seconds long. Maybe you can tell. I think you'd get this song more from a split second than this part, but here you go.
Американская фирма Transceptor Technology приступила к производству компьютеров персональный спутник.
That's the part that usually was cut out in this song. Do you know it?
Is it Pure Energy? I don't know.
All right, I'll play you the part that you will definitely get. Ready? And this is 1/1000th of a second. I know you can get it.
I've got the power.
Yeah.
Snap. I think it was Snap.
Yes, it was Snap. Very good. That was very typical of those songs that were, you know, it was some lady singing. All right.
This is tough.
Yeah, this is kind of tough. All right. Oh, here's another one that only 1/1000th of a second is necessary. I guarantee you, you've heard this. You'll get it. Here it is. 1 second song. Name that song. Come on. Come on, you know it. People in the chat, you got to get it.
I don't think I know the name of it, though. I've heard it 100 times.
You've heard it if you've been to any sporting event ever.
Y'all ready for this? Nah.
Yeah.
I've got power.
What's it called? Is it called Ready for This or something? I don't know.
It's Get Ready for This by 2 Unlimited. Yeah. The number 2. Yeah.
These are so hard.
They're so hard. Okay. I don't know if you'll get this one. This was a club hit. I played this in the clubs. It did get some airplay, but not a lot. Here's your 1 second. There's somebody in the chat. They're like, that's my jam. That's my jam.
One more time.
I know you. Come on.
Can I give you the artist?
Yeah.
Is it like Crystal Waters or something?
No. In the chat are hinting. They're giving it to you.
Blue? Blue? What is blue? I don't know what blue is.
It's by Eiffel. It's called Blue. I'm blue. You don't know that song?
I'm a kid of the 80s. Oh. In the 90s, we were playing all these songs on the radio, but you and I were planning the next segment of the show while the song was playing. I don't know this stuff.
Oh, man, that was, man, I wore out that record. Okay, here's one. I know that you'll know this. I'll give you a hint. There was a skit on Saturday Night Live that used this song a lot.
Oh, can I go ahead and guess?
Go ahead and guess.
Hadaway, What Is Love?
What is?
Yes. I mean, you didn't even need to.
What is?
Baby, don't hurt me. Baby, don't. Who were those guys? What were they called?
It was Will Ferrell. What were their names? They did a whole movie, Night at the Roxy or something.
That's
like that.
That's right. They did, didn't they? Wow, they've made movies out of anything.
Yeah.
All right. Here's another song. This, I know you like this song. 1 second song. Name this song.
Waterfalls by TLC?
Yes! Wow, don't go chasing waterfalls. Stick to the rivers and streams that you're used to. Left Eye Lopez. Such a shame. Oh my goodness. Okay. This song, we played so much at K-Fox 95.
K-Fox 95. Lufkin, Texas.
Remember when all the liners were like that? They tried to make it sound, and they had like, one of them I heard for a rock station once, I'd never forgot. It was like,
blowing the leaves out of the trees, Eagle 104, the mothership.
Remember that stuff?
The mothership.
You remember our studio was right there on the highway?
Oh.
And the guy that worked 7 to midnight was a kid named Chris Love. He calls me. It must have been about 9:30. He says, Kelly. I said, Chris, what's up, man? He said, I'm underneath the table. I said, you're underneath the table. Oh, what's going on? He said, we just had a drive-by shooting. Somebody shot the window out. I said, why are you calling me? Why aren't you calling the police? He said, well, you're my program director. I wanted to call you first.
Oh,
I said,
my
no. Hang up right now and call the police.
Oh, my God.
A drive-by at the station.
They're playing too much Hadaway.
Could have been.
Yeah, I mean, that's understandable. That's what the cops said. The cops came and said, were you playing Hadaway? And they're like, yeah. And like, well, hey, it's out of our hands. Okay. All right. This song will stick with you for the rest of the night. Name this song. Wrong button. Name this song.
Yeah, I know that there was pain.
Yeah, that's same,
but yeah, I know that there was pain.
I love how you try to sing it out in your head.
Yeah, it's not working. Somebody help. Oh, it's like Wilson
Phillips.
Yes.
Oh, hold on. Somebody
yes.
in the chat, hold on.
Wilson Phillips. Yes.
I was so in love with the blonde with the short hair in that group.
Were you?
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, she
Crushed
was a looker.
Hard on her.
She was a looker, for sure. All right. Oh, this song. Oh, my gosh. I know you'll get it, and I'm going to give you half a second, okay? Huh? Half a second. Hold on. I know you got it. Let's see if anybody in the chat gets it. There's one. What? 1 second. Now you're playing the entire song in your head, aren't you?
Oh yeah, they're getting it. Okay, here's the question.
Yeah.
Who sang it? And how do you spell it?
Oh yes, that's true. They did a weird spelling. Mm-hmm. Everybody knows, but nobody knows the. Nobody knows. Well, here it is. Where did you go? Where did you come from? Cutting a joke. God, that was a hit. Can you believe it?
Oh, wow. That was a big hit. Rednecks. Yeah. Good job, Kimbo FPV.
Rednecks. Yeah. All right. And I know you were in love with this person. I think you were. This is bringing back so many memories of just sticking in the carts. Again, if you don't know, in the 90s and 80s, if you heard music on the radio station, they were played on one of these. That's a cart. How are my tattoos looking? Gorgeous, 1080p. Hmm?
Very good. Have you got anything new lately?
Yeah, I got Thug Life.
Oh, that's okay.
You don't want, okay. Yeah. You see my
Give me that song again.
Yeah. There it is.
I have no idea. I don't know.
Really? All right. If I give you the name of the person, C.C. Peniston.
Finally, it happened.
Yeah, it came along. All right. So, what's the tally for our potential winner?
Probably giving me 10, and maybe I've gotten 4. That's not good.
No, it isn't. All right. There's just a few more. A few more chances. Now, I'm going to give you this one for 1/1000th of a second. Guaranteed, everybody will get this. Guaranteed. You ready?
Yes.
Name the song.
Everybody dance now.
Did you get it? Yeah. Feel the music. Yeah. Feel the music. Yeah. Okay.
CNC Music Factory.
Yes, CNC Music Factory. Yep. Okay, you might not get this one. This is a slow jam for the ladies.
Oh.
All right. 1 second song. Name this song.
One more time. Oh. It's I Swear by All for One?
I swear.
Yeah.
By the moon and the stars in the sky.
Hold up those lighters. Didn't everybody have a number in their band name back then?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Prince started that whole thing.
People are thinking it's 98 degrees, Boys to Men. It's all the same, right? All right. Oh, this is a good one. This may be a trick.
Uh-oh.
Name this 1 second song.
Oh yeah. All right, now this is it's not The Police and Every Breath You Take.
Mm.
This is Puff Daddy.
Uh-huh.
And Mace.
Oh.
And their tribute to Big, what was his name? Big Papa something.
Biggie Smalls.
And I think it was called I'll Be Missing You.
Yes, very good. And that was that song where they just took the Police song and added a beat to it. I mean, it's the same. That's it. It's just, it's not a sample. They sampled it.
There was no sampling.
It took the whole song.
They were stealing.
All right, I got 2 more. And that's it. A 1 second song.
All right.
Name, and I'll give you a little bit more of this one. Okay. Name this song.
We're going to dance.
See if people in the chat can get it. I'm curious.
I don't know it.
We're going to dance.
You don't know it? I bet
no
you
idea.
Do. had a great video. Great video. Back when MTV played videos.
D-Light? Groove is in the heart? Is that Groove is in the heart?
Yes.
Never
would have
gotten that.
Na 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 na. Na 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 na. Yeah, that was a good one too.
Woo!
All right, so how? Where are we with the tally?
I'm 6 out of 13.
Did he win?
Sure, he won.
Yay! Congratulations! If you win something, make sure you email me because I forget. Just remind me. Yeah, you could probably just say you won and I'll send you something anyway. Please don't do that. I'll run out of stuff.
Oh, you started something now.
I know. Hey, Ken, I won. Me too. Yeah. I won your car. Don't you remember? All right. So here's the last one. Okay? And if you don't get this, then you weren't alive in the 90s. Last 1 second song. I know you'll get it, but give people in the chat a chance.
Dance. Dance.
Come on.
Dance.
Dance. Oh, 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 is it Ice Ice Baby?
Yes. With the rag top down so my hair can blow. Girlie's on standby.
My daughter's 11 and she can rap that whole thing.
Really?
Yeah, that's a song that's stood the test of time.
Well, it's funny you should say that, because I did something back when, this is from a long time ago. This is from the year 2000. Remember? The year 2000! That was a long time ago. And I had a, what was it? A 486 SX computer.
Oh.
Ooh, Todd Fox, thank you for the $10 super chat. Happy birthday. I'll send you some breezes. Thanks, man. Thank you. Do you remember Slim Shady, Eminem?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
The real Slim Shady. You know all
yes.
that? Someone bet me that I couldn't mix Eminem into a bunch of TV theme songs. And I did it. And for my birthday, I want to share this with you as my gift to you. This is from 19 years ago, created on a very old, slow computer. This took me days to do. And I didn't use a fancy program. You know, now you can just, you know, here, computer, here's this song, make a mix. Back then it was like calculator, slide rule. Do over, undo. I'm using something called Gold Wave. Anyway, it turned out okay. So here is my special TV Eminem Mega Medley. Enjoy.
Rolling, rolling, rolling. Yeah! Rolling, rolling, rolling. Cause I'm Slim Shady, yes, I'm the real Shady. All you other Slim Shadys are just imitating. So won't the real Slim Shady please stand up? Please stand up. Please stand up. Yeah, I probably got a couple of screws up in my head loose, but no worse than what's going on in your parents' bedrooms. But sometimes I want to get on TV and just let loose, but can't. But it's cool for Tom Green to hump a dead moose. Rolling, rolling, rolling. We ain't nothing but mammals. Rolling, rolling. Well, some of us cannibals. Rolling, rolling. They got the Discovery Channel, don't they? Cause I'm Slim Shady. May I have your attention, please? May I have your attention, please? Will the real Slim Shady please stand up? I'm Slim Shady, yes, I'm the real Shady. All you other Slim Shady, so just stand up. So won't the real Slim Shady please stand up? Please stand up, please stand up.
What do you think?
That's awesome.
I mixed this with... I won't tell you. You just have to listen. It turned out better than I thought. The next one.
We're gonna have a problem here. May I have your attention, please?
Please stand up.
I repeat.
Please stand up.
Y'all act like you've never seen a white person before. Jaws all on the floor like Pam, like Tommy just burst in the door.
Please stand up.
I repeat.
My bum is on your lips.
That's
my
the Jeffersons.
And if that's I love you, awesome. Might just give it a little kiss.
Cause I'm Slim Shady, yes, I'm the real Shady. All you other Slim Shadys are just imitating. So won't the real Slim Shady please stand up?
guess there's a Slim Shady in all of us.
Yeah! Thank you.
Wow.
That took me a week.
Jefferson's was just, I mean, that's epic.
That took me a week.
How long would it take you now if you had to do that, start from scratch?
5 hours. I mean, if I'd wanted to do something like that, right. But there are programs that'll just slap a dappa doodle stuff together for you. But I did it, like, I did it digitally, but I did it the hard way. Anyway.
Right.
I'm glad you liked it.
Awesome.
So, let's check out this video from one of our French viewers. His name is Pascal Bedard. He says, "Hey, Ken, like you, I started FPV in May this year. Now flying my Phantom 4 Pro is not boring, but if you want to see luck, you can look to the end of this video. My Diatone 349 landed inches from the water." And I put some translations in here for you. Here he is. A close call, indeed. So his drone stuck in the tree.
Oh, no.
Yeah. So what do you do when your drone's stuck in the tree? Oh, you get a stick.
Get a chainsaw.
Yeah, you're right, you're right. Or, that didn't work, so you throw rocks at it. That's what you do.
Oh, no, no.
And it worked. But, check out where it landed. Oh my goodness. You lucked out, buddy.
Wow.
What do you think, dog? Pretty cool, huh?
Lucky break.
So what have I missed tonight? Oh, I know what I missed. We gotta talk about Loom Cube! Ah, Loom Cube! Where's my pop-up? There it is. Loom Cube! We love Loom Cube. Thank you very much for sponsoring the show, Loom Cube. You know, they've got so many great products. In fact, they have a new one coming up very soon.
What is it? What is it? What is it?
I can't really say.
Give me a hint.
I'll give you a hint in video. Here's the video hint. It's coming up very soon, and it will change the way you take pictures. What is that? What could it be? That's all you get.
Oh.
Yeah, so they're sending me one. It's a, well, it's from Loom Cube, so you know it's going to be something that lights up, right?
Right, right.
So there you go, yeah.
And it goes on your forehead?
Yeah, you attach it directly to your forehead, and what happens is, no. So there's a new LED light coming from Loom Cube very soon, and I'll feature it here on this channel.
Nice.
Now, Loom Cube has been kind enough to give me a discount code for everything that you'll buy. Using this code, it'll help the channel, and I'd sure appreciate it if you're planning on getting anything from Loom Cube to use this code, because then it will help your pal Ken and the channel. It's TNL10. TNL as in Thursday Night Live 10. And you'll get a 10% discount on everything on Loom Cube, including the strobe.
The strobe is nice, isn't it?
Yeah, it is very nice. And are you going to be able to help me film this thing we're doing for Loom Cube?
Yeah, we've been trying to put this together. When are we doing this? The disco ball in the sky. Are we going to try and do that this weekend or what?
Yeah, you got time? Like Sunday or something?
Sunday, I'll be heading to Nashville for wrestling where I'm on the front row ringside, brother. Come back. Please come back. Come on back.
I'm back. So maybe Saturday? We'll talk about it later. But anyway, Loom Cube. Go to loomcube.com. Check out the stuff they got. Use TNL10 for a discount. Love you. Mean it, Loom Cube.
Aww.
Awesome. So now here is Kelly Green with a joke.
Why did the can crusher quit his job? Why did the can crusher quit his job?
Why did the can crusher quit his job? Why?
Because it was soda pressing.
That's pretty good, man. I actually like that. Alexa, tell me a joke.
What do you call an angry coach?
What?
A cross trainer.
Oh, I don't know. I don't know which one's better.
What?
I'm not sure. I'm on the fence.
So depressing.
Cross trainer, that's pretty good. Give me another one.
All right. This is the classic.
Okay.
And we'll put me against Alexa in this round of jokes, and they can decide in the chat.
Okay.
What did the cat say after eating two robins lying in the sun?
What did the cat say after eating two robins lying in the sun? What?
I just love Baskin Robbins.
Alexa, tell me a joke.
Why did the turtle break up with the giraffe?
Why?
They never saw eye to eye.
No!
I think I'm leaning towards that one.
Baskin Robbins or turtle in the chat.
Yeah.
Which one's better?
Let us know. You don't like it when you're competing against her, do you?
No. I work hard on these jokes.
Does it hurt your feelings? I'm sorry.
Yes.
I'm sorry. Hey, how about to make you feel a little bit better, we do some Raz to the Mataz in gorgeous 1080p. Oh, can you believe it? Oh my goodness gracious. Here
it's
we
even
are.
It's razzier than before.
It's 10% more Raz. Yes, it's good for this essential breakfast. 1080p, full HD Raz. I still have Razzmatazz t-shirts available for those who would like to take the Raz on the road with you. Raz on the road. Everything is good here in the Raz. Nothing bad can happen to you. All right, and we're back. That's so weird. But you know what isn't weird?
What's that?
Giving away something. It's time. It's been 2 weeks. And it's time to give away the Crane M2 gimbal. This is for mirrorless cameras. And if you saw my video, then you know what I'm talking about. This is a
nice.
Really cool gimbal. It's really, really good. It's from Juin. I never know how to say it. It's not Jiyun, it's Juin. Juin. It's Juin. Juin. Anyway, it's these guys right here. And now it's time to head into the Decideratron 5000. As we
wow.
Go. Yeah, yeah. We got the Decideratron 5000. Where's my Decideratron 5000 music? Oh, no, wait. Oh, yes. There it is. All right, the Decideratron 5000. Let's see who's going to win this thing. If you commented, then you are eligible. Let's see how many people we got. I'm going to filter out the duplicate users. Now, I did ask you to say a certain thing. And if you said that certain thing, and also you had to email me, since this is a pretty pricey prize. So we're going to see here. So you have a 1 in 299 chance of winning. And let's start it up and see who wins. The winner is Mark Rogers. Mark Rogers, congrats. Wait a minute, is that Tater? I think that's Tater. So let's see if he emailed me, because it's what you had to do as well. And yes, he did. You had to know the principles of internal medicine from the video. So congratulations. Oh my gosh, Tater won. I imagine him and his son Tater Tot will have a lot of fun with this. That's what he calls him, for real. Yeah. Congrats, buddy. I'll send that to you.
Speaking of which, what are your thoughts on the Osmo Mobile 3 that came out, what, last week?
Yeah, I mean, the only difference is that it folds, right?
That's what I'm seeing.
It doesn't look like it does. I mean, it does all the things that you'd expect a DJI product to do, you know, like
yeah,
cost more and look pretty. But it folds, and, you know, if you already have a gimbal, I mean, all right, look, get one if you have a small purse.
Hmm.
Eh, and just, eh, you know.
Yeah.
So, all right, we did that. What else did we miss?
Is DJI releasing products because they have such a big fan base that they know no matter what they release, they're going to make money off of it because people buy stuff because they're DJI?
Yes.
Okay, just checking.
The answer to that is yes. By the way, I'm going to head out with my DJI product this Friday, tomorrow.
Where are you going?
I think I'm going to go the Memphis way.
Oh.
I don't know if I'm going to go to Memphis, but I'll go out that way. If you have any ideas for me of where to film, please email me. Let me know. If you want to meet up, we can do that too. It's the day after my birthday, so I can do whatever the hell I want.
Are you going to visit your sister, your loving sister, Julie, while you're there?
Yes, I am. Aww. We're going to have dinner together. I'm going to let her buy.
She's a doctor. She better.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. She lives in Germantown. What's that sound for Germantown? There it is. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So if you're enjoying the show tonight and it's our first show in 1080, hopefully you can see all of the grain in the wood of my paneling palace here. And you might also be able to see something that I discovered recently on me. And I want you to tell me in the chat to help make me feel better. Here's the question. Does anybody other than me have gray arm hair? There's a dude that he's an old drone flyer. He's like 80 or whatever. And he did an unboxing. And he's got like jet black arm hair. What's up with that? Why am I gray? Why do I got to do that? Why do I have to have gray arm hair? Am I going to have to start shaving?
Is it all gray?
No, it's just gray in weird places. It's like gray right here where I can see it. If it was gray over here, I wouldn't care. Just be gray, you know, but over here. And it really interferes with my whole tattoo stuff. Do you remember Gary that used to do videos with me?
Yeah.
He shaves his arms.
My wife tries to do that to me.
To shave your arms?
Yeah, she thinks they're too hairy.
Are you going to do it?
No!
How does she broach that subject? How does she say, honey?
You really want to know?
Yeah, tell me, man.
When she's shaving my back, she tries to kind of drift over. She drifts over to my arm.
Oh, no. Please hold. Your viewership is important to us. I'm going to be over here recovering for a minute. She's shaving your back. How often does she have to do that?
Usually if we're going to like a water park or a beach or anywhere where I'm going to be shirtless.
We are so oversharing. Oh my gosh. And she says, all right, well, I'm done mowing your back. Can I weed whack your arms now?
No, she just starts drifting over. I'm like, what are you doing?
Oh, she doesn't ask. She just starts.
No. No.
Do you have? Oh my God! All right. Okay. So Danny Lopez has gray arm hair. 400 AGL. We're gonna talk to him in here in a minute. He has gray arm hair. So I guess I don't feel that bad, but I don't know if I'm gonna shave it.
Do you shave your tats? Like, do you shave your arms so your tats will show better?
No, if I want them to look better, I just moisturize. That's what I do. I just moisturize a little bit. All right, let's change the subject. And speaking of good resolution, which is why I brought up the arm hair to begin with, the reason why I'm able to do that is because I've got fiber now, a form of fiber, fiber light, let's say. I'm not like one of you lucky people out there with, you know, 1,000 down, 1,000 up reciprocal, but it's a lot better. So I'm able to broadcast this in 1080. So I have a demonstration of a before and after with a speed test, and I added a little music for dramatic effect. So here's what my internet speed was like before the change, before the upgrade. And this is one of the reasons why I really appreciate all the super chats, because in order to bring this show to you, it's quite pricey a month. So thank you very much, everybody who did that. It's a great birthday present, and I appreciate you supporting the show. So there you go. That's pretty much standard for download.
Not bad.
Not bad at all. That's kind of what it was at the radio station. This is my home internet. And so that's pretty much standard fare upload for the basic package. You need a little bit more than five to get good streamage. But then I did the upgrade. Pretty good. And now, oh, lordy lord. Hang on to your seats, get buckled in. Drop that bass on you! This is Upload! In a small town! In Tennessee! Go, baby, go! Woo-hoo, yeah! Yeah! Now, just to make everybody feel better about their internet, here's what it's like in Australia. The music is appropriate. This is Greg Kuhnert. We were doing some tests the other night, and you can see he is not happy. He's in the lower right. This is his upload. It's okay. I mean, his download. His download's okay. Here's his upload. Come on. Maybe the needle's stuck. Tap on it like it's a plane gauge. Oh, that's abysmal. Abysmal. Wow. So there you go. So I have this fancy new internet, and
man, that's lightning.
Wasn't it great? Yeah. Let me know if you have fiber in the chat, because I'll be going back to check this out later. And I want to feel bad about myself. Mm. Yeah. So Kelly, how long's the show been? It's been pretty long, hasn't it? Probably need to
two hours, 15 minutes, 20
right.
minutes.
That's pretty standard. People still interested?
Everybody? Oh my goodness, somebody in Canada gets 2.58 down and 0.34 up.
Oh my goodness, no way.
Can't drive 55. Sorry about that, man.
Ah. Oh. Well, we still have a little over 200 people watching, so I guess people are interested. And now while I bring in our next special guest, someone who I have to thank for making all of this possible. Here is Kelly with yet one more joke.
Where do cows hang their paintings? Where do cows hang their paintings?
Where?
In the museum.
That's pretty good. Alexa, tell me a joke.
The works of the Impressionists weren't very popular in their day, but now they're worth a ton of Monet.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's Mel, 400 AGL. What's up, man?
Happy birthday to you.
Aw, thanks.
Happy birthday to you.
Oh, he's going
to
do the whole thing. Okay. Welcome, and thank you so much for being on. I appreciate it. And I have to thank you in front of everyone. Because if it weren't,
everyone, don't embarrass me.
If it weren't for Mel and his brother Kent, I'd be doing this show from the street, because
at least the front porch, maybe.
Yeah, I hired some. If you don't know, if you haven't noticed already, I moved the operation from the radio station to my house because it's a little bit more convenient for me. So I hired a couple of dudes come over and do that, and they took the stuff out of the radio station, put it in the truck, and then left. And I said, there's a second part to this. Okay.
And they were waving bye-bye. They said, we got to go eat now.
And they were gone. So
they were gone.
It was just me and Mel and his brother, and Brandy was there for a minute. But, man.
Thank God for Brandy. She dug up a bunch of extra boxes that
she did.
Totally came in handy.
But you and your brother, thank you from the bottom of my heart for making that possible.
You're very welcome. That's what neighbors do, man. That's what neighbors do.
Yeah, and I don't know how many people know this, but Mel has a bum knee, and I felt bad every time he's carrying something heavy up the stairs. And I have a glass back. I broke my back 3 times, so I can't help. But,
so
you know,
we wouldn't let him either. We wouldn't let him lift anything. If he picked up something heavier than an ink pen, we were slapping his hands.
Yeah.
And I'm really lazy, so I couldn't help.
Right.
Well, you didn't even show up. That's how lazy you are.
I asked him to, But somehow,
you know, and it's too bad, Ken, that he didn't show up because he missed out on all the free beer and pizza.
What? Right, right. And what about those gold bricks I gave everybody?
Gold bricks.
Yeah, gold
bricks.
From
the donut shop across the street when we got all yeah, it was awesome.
Yeah.
Kelly, you blew it, dude. You blew it.
Yeah. Hey, you might as well give out my address now, Mel.
I don't know it.
How many donut shops are there in town? Oh, Ken lives near the donut shop. Let's go visit him.
I know where it is, but I couldn't tell you where it is.
I got to tell you, please donut visit me unannounced.
Oh,
because you'll be eating some lead. Pew, 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 pew.
What happened to the movers? They just bailed on you? They just left?
Yeah. Something with their kids or something. Some kid.
I think it had something to do with kids and who knows.
Something. Isn't that the thing that parents can always do, though? Right? They can pull out, my kid is, spin the wheel, sick. Kid is sick.
Yeah.
You know, and who can say anything about that? Well, you said you'd help me move or your kid is sick. Okay, fine. Go take care of your kid, your sick kid. Anyway, Mel,
They did help get the heavy stuff down the stairs.
They did. And I think it was when they found out that the heavy stuff had to go up some stairs, they were like, sick kid. Yeah. But
I think that had something to do with
it. Yeah, but thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Your brother, Kent, is a mule. And I mean that... In the best way possible.
In the email, I said, Ken, I'll be there. Tell me what time. I'll bring my forklift, aka brother. Did I not put that in the email?
Yeah, and we had to watch him, too, because, you know, you guys are both over 50, and Ken, he'll like, keep going. I had to, like, he didn't ask for water. He started sweating. I could see him kind of fading. I'm like, dude, sit down, man. He just keep going till he fell over. He's such a nice guy. Both of you.
Yep.
So anyway, this wouldn't be possible without you.
Well, you're very welcome. And the room looks really good. I mean, I know you showed it to me earlier today and everything, but yeah, it looks, you got it going on.
Thanks, man. Appreciate it. So maybe I can do something for you. We can all do something for Mel by subscribing to his channel tonight. How many That'd subscribers be cool. do you have, Mel?
Right 960. Now?
Okay, so maybe we can push him up to 1,000. Wouldn't that be great?
That'd be great, or 1,100. I mean, you got 250 watching.
Okay,
20 of them are already subscribers, probably.
Okay, well,
that'd be really cool.
Yeah, just go ahead. There's a link in the description if you want to subscribe. Just look up Foreign AGL. I like your new background, by the way.
Well, thank you very much.
Yeah, looks like you're in a comedy club.
Yeah, and. It's all getting torn down in the morning.
Oh, and where are you headed?
Moving my studio to Fort Smith, Arkansas temporarily.
Okay.
Yep.
And
so my show will be live from Fort Smith on Sunday. And Read It and Weep, I will have 300 symmetrical up and down.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, I would move for fiber. More fiber.
Yeah, fiber's awesome.
Give me the fiber. Well, Mel, thank you so much for stopping by. I appreciate it. And you're a good friend.
Can I do two things before you go? First,
No.
I'm going to show you the gray hair.
You're going to do it anyway. Oh, man.
And, you know, let's talk about Kelly, right?
Right. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Spin up.
Yep.
Coming up.
October 19th, Kelly Shores.
That's my two plugs, gray hair and spin up.
There you go.
Thank awesome. You very much, Ken.
Thank you, sir.
I appreciate it.
All right, we'll talk to you later.
We'll see you.
See you, man. All right. That guy's the best. I'm telling you, if I needed a kidney, he'd sell me one.
That's how you know who your true friends are. When you're in a jam and you're moving, your true friends will help you move.
Oh, moving sucks.
It's the worst.
I don't know if I would even... I think I would manufacture some sick kids myself. Man. Kelly, if I needed a kidney, would you give me a kidney if I was going to die without it?
If you're going to die without it?
Yeah, and we were a match somehow.
And I've got two, right?
You got two.
You're on the spot. How old are you at this time? How old are you at this time? Are you your current age or are you like 80?
I'm my current age, and... it's bad news for me if I don't get that kidney, and you're the only one that's got a viable one.
Yeah, I'd give you one.
You would?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, man, that's awesome. Ask me if but I would
not,
give you one.
Nope, I'm not even going to ask. I know the answer. Don't ever ask a question you don't want to know the answer to.
All right, let's go ahead and get to the viewer video of the week, shall we?
Let's do it, please, all right. Quickly.
This is from Casey Reitzman, and he Reitzman. Hey, Ken, I wanted to share with you the best clips I've shot so far. I bought my Mavic 2 Pro 5 months ago, only 5 months ago. When I was getting ready to buy my drone back in March, I started watching drone videos on YouTube, and that's how I found you. I've been enjoying your videos ever since and watch TNL every Thursday. I'm also getting into FPV drones as well, so it's great that you are going through the same thing. Looking forward to more of those videos in the future. Thanks, Casey Reitzman. So he sent me this video, and it's a great, great video. I took the liberty of editing it a little bit for time, and I changed the music. And the reason why I'm mentioning this is because a lot of you who are posting videos will use your favorite song, and I encourage you not to do that, especially if you plan on monetizing your channel down the road. I have a lot of videos on my channel that I did for years using copyrighted music, and it's just not a good idea if your ultimate plan is to monetize. So he used a song by Imagine Dragons, and he edited it to the video, to the music, and it fit really great. It's still a great video, and I hope you can forgive me that I use different music. But here it is, the viewer video of the week. It's from Casey Reitzman. And he's only had his drone 5 months. What do you think, Kelly? He's got a future or what?
Very nice. Yeah, thumbs up, man.
Nice, straight, purposeful shots. Tracking very nicely.
Wow.
A lot of newbies will be herky-jerky with it. You just have to be nice, slow, and steady, and purposeful with your movements. Clearly, he's got some video editing chops. Beautiful. Very, very well done.
Yeah, that's awesome. That guy, he's been practicing, I'm sure. That's terrific, man.
I could watch people fly through palm trees like for an hour. Wasn't that cool?
Yeah.
That's great. Casey Reitzman, thank you. Well,
what do you get when you become the viewer video of the week? What do you win? What do you get for that?
You get your choice of Freewell filters.
Do you really?
Yeah. Yeah, they recently let me give two sets of filters away per show. So congratulations. Make sure you email me and let me know what kind of filters you would like from Freewell. And we thank Freewell very much for sponsoring the show. Kelly, again, I want to apologize in front of everybody for the start of the show. I kind of lost my ever-loving mind in the beginning. I mean, I lost it.
Yeah, I've seen it once. You've seen it 1,000 times. And I've seen it 1,000 times.
You have, haven't you? But anyway, hopefully next week will go smoother. I'm going to go ahead and go downstairs and spend some quality time with Henry. And it's time to head out.
We hope you enjoyed the show half as much as you would have if it had been twice as good.
Thank you, everybody. Thanks, Kelly Green, for co-hosting. Thank you, Wolfgang Weber, for being on and talking with us about what it's like to be a big, huge Hollywood superstar. And Joe Smithers for sharing that cool cliff video, and Jeff Sills for the news. And yes, happy birthday to me. Thanks so much for the super chats. Next week on the show will be Joshua Bardwell, FPV genius, and Jerry will co-host. Until then,
and bye.
killer crosses me.
Say ah.
Enjoy pigeon jerky.
Pigeon jerky.
And you'll give your family a treat. It's delicious nutrition to help them grow. And it's full of fiber to make them grow. You enjoy pigeon jerky.
That was so funny.